7:57 in the a.m. here, Eastern Standard Time. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Today is January 20th, 2017. Out with the old, in with the new. Whether you like it or not, Donald Trump is going to be the 45th president of the United States. And I am going to say congratulations to Mr. Trump, because considering what he was up against and everybody that said it couldn't be done and it would never happen, well, ha-ha, it's happening. So, get used to it. It is what it is. Now, last night, during the Sean Bergen show, and my mic is really low here.
No,
so, yeah, hold on just one. There we go. A little bit better there. You know, it's last night during the Sean Bergen show, we actually had a gentleman by the name of Alan Jacoby. Alan is with the Nassau County Fife and Drum, who are marching in the parade, the inauguration parade. But they were in a restaurant on, I think they said South 4th Street, if I'm not mistaken, last night, and they had locked the doors of the restaurant because of what was going on outside the restaurant. I don't know whether you guys have had the opportunity to view any of the videos or anything of the protest, but it was literally, it made the North Carolina and Charleston protests look like a Boy Scout meeting. It was sickening. It really was. And reports, and they actually had a report of a gentleman that was detained who was at a company, actually had a company out of California that was hiring people and paying them to protest. This is, you know, I mean, the reports, what was it, CNN coming out yesterday with a report and suggesting someone assassinate, you know, Trump during the inauguration. And it was just, this whole thing is sick. It really is. It's a damn shame. Well, again, this is not a conversation to say whether Trump is right or Trump is wrong. This is what I'm saying here is, he was elected, whether you like it or not. He's going to be sworn in today as the President of the United States. You can stand on your head, bounce across the room, you know, have hissy fits, you know, bang your head on store windows, you know, wear anti-Trump t-shirts, curse him out, do whatever you want to do. But the bottom line is that today, Mr. Trump will become President Trump and the 45th President of the United States.
Wait, where do I get these t-shirts?
Wait, you didn't get a T-shirt.
I didn't get the T-shirt. It was supposed to be sent to me.
It was sent. No, you didn't get the.
Got a little echo.
You got a little echo. I don't know why. I don't have an echo. I didn't. Nobody gave me an echo.
Because somebody left the volume up on his phone.
All right, listen, guys. Let's clear the air right here. I'm going to say this right now. Okay. When I come in here in the morning, I have a procedure that I go through. All right, I get my
regardless of what time
right,
you get in.
I know I got in late this morning because I overslept, and I apologize for that. But when I get in the morning, I go through a procedure here. Okay, I get the news up, I set the music up, I do what you know, I get myself together here. All right, so I don't need texts in the morning telling me that my Skype is not on or I'm not answering this or I'm not doing. I know you're out there. I get it. I understand. And in a few seconds, I'm going to take a short break here, and I will get to it. I will do it, okay? So just everybody take a chill pill and relax, all
right? This is just America's way of protesting. It's the American way.
All right? I don't need to, you know, I know. I see it. I'm sitting right here. I get it. I understand. I will turn it on. It will happen in a moment. Absolutely happen in a moment. So anyway, I'm just.
The same crap he tells his wife every
night. I'm talking right now. Not you. I don't mean it. That's not what I'm saying. I'm saying something right now, and my phone's going, ding! I get it. I understand. I hear you. I know you're out there. I get it.
Wow.
Anyway, so how are you, Jim?
I'm all right. I forgot to put my sensitive panties on today.
Do you want me to lie? I'm being honest.
It's okay, Eric. Don't worry about it. We love you.
Do you still have an echo?
No. Okay. It was my phone.
Was it going ding, ding, ding?
No, it was going ding, ding.
It wasn't
ding,
going ding. Ding.
Because nobody loves me.
Would you do me a favor? Yes, would you text me and ding my phone and tell me that the TV's not on behind
sure,
you?
Because
nobody's
that?
Done that yet.
Can I do that?
No, you know what? It's just been the past couple of days have been really like draining, if you want to call it that, you know, and because I've been, when I tell you that I have really seriously been working my.
Ding.
Am I kidding? Am I kidding?
I thought you were playing that sound on your board or something.
Jay's like, ding! Ha ha, love you.
Ding,
you dick. You know? Oh, Lord. My goodness. No, it's like I've really seriously hitting the bricks, sales, you know, talking to people out there. And we brought on a bunch of new shows, you know, doing the shows, producing the shows, really taking. I'm not saying that I haven't been taking things seriously, but if you're going to do something like this, you either dive into it 100%. You know, there is no 95%. There is no 90%. You know, and we're really seriously the focus. You know, the focus. You just have to be focused. So we have focus, man. Be focused.
You got to be focused.
You have to be focused. You know,
got to keep your eyes on the price.
You know, they landed your buddy at MacArthur last night.
I was just reading about
that. Did you see that?
I did not know anything about this.
Can you? I mean, the Mexican drug lord, El Chapo. As a matter of fact, we have him on the phone right now. Sir, I understand that they landed you at MacArthur Airport last night.
Oh, Jen, I want to tell you something.
No peanuts on the plane?
Nice place, though.
You like that? You're thinking about it?
Oh, damn, yeah. I was thinking of relocating him permanently.
You think so?
Like to Brentwood?
Well, I think you may be. I think you might be relocating permanently into Brooklyn.
Don't worry, we're gonna work something out, man. Because everybody told me in America, cash is king.
Yeah, you look at his face last night, and he didn't look happy, did he?
I can't imagine he was. You know, really.
You know, what the hell am I doing here, man? They didn't even a real airport, man.
It's bad enough I had to live in Mexico. Now they got me on Long Island. I don't like this place.
That's it.
The only thing is like there's Starbucks all over the place, and I love that shit.
You love Starbucks?
Oh, God dang. I got the app on my phone.
We were talking to Antonio the other night, who lives in Shanghai.
Yeah.
And Phil's questions to him were like, do they have Taco Bell? And Antonio was like, yeah, they just opened one up.
You're right. It sounds funny, a Taco Bell in Shanghai.
Taco Bell. He says they got Taco Bell. They have KFC. They have Frank wanted to know if they have McDonald's. Phil wanted Taco Bell. You know? But they said that the he was funny because they were saying, boy, I bet you get tired of Chinese food. He goes, no, actually, I crave the Chinese food that they have here in the States.
Oh, that's funny.
You know, he says, because it's Chinese food they have in China. It's not Chinese food. That made sense. But anyway, so if you haven't heard that show yet, that, you know, Standing on Principle the other night was a really great show with Antonio actually was told at 7 years old that he was dyslexic and also had issues with writing. You know, he would never write. But this gentleman now, he speaks fluent.
He's brilliant.
Major languages. He's graduated from numerous universities all over the world, including a PhD from Shanghai University. He lived in the temple with the monks, and he's a martial artist. He's known as the Brooklyn Monk, you know, and really, in his job right now, what he does is he compiles the news based on they call it Trump America.
Okay.
So what it is he compiles the news based on trade between China or the news with regards to Trump, and he reports and he puts that together in a report every day so that the Chinese and the government basically know what's going on. So he's got a hell of a job. You know?
Healthy looking guy. Did anybody test his blood to see if he's open?
I wanted Frank to fight him, but he wouldn't do it.
No, I want to see what kind of shape his kidneys are in.
I'm sure.
We're thinking about you, Gianna.
I see that. Oh, absolutely.
We're looking for kidneys.
We talk about Gianna on every show. And we actually ran into a couple of people. I think I told you this. I'm not going to say who, but I ran into a couple of people who are O blood type.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so we're, you know. The thing is, you have to really, even if you are O blood type, you really have to want to do this.
Of course, because, I think that's first and foremost.
There's a lot of there's a lot to it, you know, and it's like, you know, and I get it. Some people are they can't get away that type of thing. So it's not that they don't want to help.
Yeah.
It's that they can't because they're, you know, it's like me, like being the focal point of everybody's life.
Oh. Dear Lord.
You know, no, I'm serious. Oh. What would my wife do without having...
I'm trying to fill in for Gina. Mm. Linda doesn't care.
Yes, actually. Yeah. You know, so like I said, history is being made today. Trump to be sworn in as president. What once seemed impossible becomes reality. Donald Trump takes the oath of office to become the United States' 45th president. The brash, as they call him, billionaire, who rode voter discontent to victory. Now, that's what I get. That's true. He rode... With all of the people, here's the thing. What I get a kick out of, Jim, is that with all of the people, all of the people that are upset with him, all of the protests, did you see any of these videos last night?
Of course.
It was sick.
You can't avoid it.
But
this is the American way we protest.
That wasn't just a protest.
I understand.
That was chaos.
Out of every 12,000 people protesting, there are going to be 45 morons breaking windows or throwing bottles at police and stuff like that. But this country's been protesting
there was some fat fat law enforcement officer. All you know, he was kind of a chubby guy, right?
Okay.
And the look on his face was like, you know, it was like he was scared out of his mind, right? Yeah. And it was funny because he was like, he had a little can of mace, like the thing that you would give a woman to keep in her pocketbook,
the pepper spray.
And he's like going right, and you could see him. He's like going left, right, and I'm looking at this guy. He's shooting this stuff in the air, like you know,
it's probably coming back.
You know, and, you know, oh my God. So anyway, all right. So no, I get it. Listen, protesting. You're right. You have a right to protest.
It's fine. Peaceful protest.
You have a right to protest. Yeah. But when is enough enough? But anyway, the thing I get a kick out of is that, and this is what they said: the brash billionaire who rode voter discontent. So if there's so many people out there that are discontent with Mr. Trump, the fact that he is become the president of the United States, yes, is that not? God bless everybody. But they say that he'll be sworn in at noon at the Capitol. Immediately afterwards, he will use his he'll have his first speech as president to try to soothe tensions. Now, can I ask you a question? I'm going to ask your opinion of something. Are you an Obama fan?
Yes, I was.
Okay, you were during his entire presidency.
Pretty much.
All right, so may I ask you a question?
I am not by any stretch saying he did everything that pleased me.
Understood.
But I was fully accepting him as a president. And I am highly skeptical of our new president.
Okay, the question is, why don't you think it would have been proper, with everything going on in Washington last night, if maybe Mr. Obama made a statement and tried to make some form of peace?
The problem is, we're thinking that would be the right thing to do. That was by the old rule book, and the rules have changed completely.
Right.
So we don't know what propriety is anymore. We have to rewrite the rule book.
Understood. Okay. Listen. The concept of this show is not to say that anybody is wrong or anybody is right. The concept that we want to establish here, and the guidelines that we are establishing for Cop and Calamity in the Morning, is that everybody is entitled to their opinion.
I'm sorry, I wasn't aware of that when I tweeted about you this morning.
That's all right. Ding me?
Ding bad.
Can you do me a favor?
Yes,
can you
of
just
course.
I don't care what you text them. I just want their phones to go ding ding. If you could just text J&G anything.
That's a great idea.
Just make their phones go ding, okay? So anyway, the bottom line is everybody is entitled to their opinion. And sometimes, as Stephen Covey, the author of The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, talks about in his book, there is something called an aha moment. Aha, mm-hmm.
Yes.
Right? Which means basically that people have a way of thinking. Right? Everybody has a way of thinking. So sooner or later, or something comes along all of a sudden, and you sit back in your chair and you go, wow, I never thought of it that way. And you see things in an entirely different perspective in a new light.
Yes.
So I think if I, and I talk for myself at this point, if I approach life in that manner to say that, you know, just because I have an opinion of something does not mean that I am 100% correct.
Usually that is
right,
the case.
Right.
Well,
you know what? I'm not going to ding you anymore. All right? You are off. You have just been taken off my ding list, okay?
Ding, damn, ding.
All right? So, you know, it's like, yes, you know, you're not – what I'm saying is that everybody's entitled to their opinion. And I'm willing to listen to everybody, even if they're wrong. So, anyway. All right.
Yeah.
So he's going to use his first speech as president to try to soothe tensions, which I don't think will happen. He's basically, in his most of his appearances last night, talking about making America great again. His message, they say, will not be heard by everyone. Dozens of Democrats are boycotting the ceremony, many due to Trump's tweets about Representative John Lewis, who he said he didn't consider Trump's win legitimate amid the evidence that Russia tried to influence the election. I would love to know.
Yes.
The truth.
Do you
I really
think
would.
We ever will?
I don't know.
Yeah, I would love to know the truth, too. And obviously, we have different opinions.
I mean, I had the situation with regards to the chit situation in Florida. You remember that?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Where Bush claimed, you know.
The hanging Chad.
Yeah. I mean, right. Do we, you know, I mean, it happens. But again, the bottom line is at this point, where we're at right now is that Mr. Trump, as of noon today, will be the 45th president of the United States. And as far as I am concerned, listen, am I scared with the things that I hear? Absolutely. Do I want to die in a nuclear holocaust? No. Do I want, you know, because I don't, I can't see myself, you know, living underground, all right, and playing Mad Max. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to do that. All right. I want to live I want to have the American dream, even at the age I'm at. I know you're done. You're going to die soon. But yeah, it's really, like, you
I'm
know,
almost finished.
You know, but no, so me
think,
too.
I mean, I think I want to pull in the walls, kind of close my house off and right. go, all right, this world I can control.
Right.
And the further away from that I get, the less control I feel I have over it.
Right.
And it is. Do boys we really and girls, it's a scary world.
Does anybody like in the world we live in, Jim, does anybody, I'm going to turn the computer volume up just a little bit here. Let me just get to it here because I wanted to see something. Bear with me. Does the world we live in, okay, truly, does anybody really have control of the way things are in the world? Who do you know that can control the way things are in the world?
It's a relative term. It does. Are there people that have more control than you do and I do?
Right.
Yes.
Okay.
So that gives them control.
Okay.
It's a relative term.
Who are the people that have control? Who would you say? The organizational groups that are protesting? Are they trying to control?
They have more control. They have less control than they would like to, more control than I have as an individual.
Right.
Does the president have more control than I do? Of course he does. Which is why if I question the way he thinks and the way he does things,
right.
it's frustrating. This is why people are protesting.
Okay.
If they disagree with him, they're protesting because they're very afraid that they have no control and he does.
Right.
Okay.
I got you. All right. So let's see. What time is it? Ooh, 8:14 in the morning. And it's 8:14 in the morning, Jim.
It's 8:14.
8:14
in the
morning.
It's that time of day. Where are?
I'm bringing them in. I'm going to bring them in. I'm going to bring them in right after I do something. Let me just. I had something here.
The boy wonder with the bad haircut and the sultry wench with the bad attitude.
Oh, now you're in a lot of trouble.
Oh, and I'm probably.
You said that. I didn't.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
You said that. I'm looking. I actually had a news story. That is this the news story I wanted to read? I don't think this was the one, but there's a lot of different things. First off, I'm going to tell you, when we come back, I'm going to tell you about the 75 leftist groups that are trying to stop Donald Trump from taking office. I'm also going to tell you 12 extremely stupid things that people have done to get themselves fired.
Oh, that could be good.
I'm telling you. You know, because I don't want to spend the entire morning talking about politics, but the bottom line is today is definitely a political day.
Yippee!
You know? All right, we'll be right back right after this.
ShowMeCountry.com. It's not just a brand, it's a...
Hello?
Wait, what do you mean? We're not doing it this way?
Stop it. No, we're not.
All right, fine.
ShowMeCountry.com.
Express your country with great products like purses, hats, shirts, belt buckles, purses, wallets, novelties, and gifts.
We have something for everyone. Hundreds of products, adding new deals daily.
Their site is 100% safe and secure.
Easy payment options like login with Amazon, PayPal, or credit debit cards.
Country means something different to everyone. Show off your country style with ShowMeCountry.com.
Not country?
Check us out anyway.
Custom orders welcome.
ShowMeCountry.com.
It's not just country, it's a lifestyle.
So check out our buddies at ShowMeCountry.com.
Hi, this is Calamity Gina from Cop and Calamity in the Morning, and you're listening to WLINY, Long Island's number one internet radio station.
Yeah.
Are you through?
How did I grow up in that era and
right.
never, ever, ever like the Beatles music? How did that happen?
You never liked the Beatles?
Never,
you were
ever.
More into like the Doors and
maybe,
music, you know. And
maybe.
And
but
you
honestly,
know,
at that time, you know, the Beatles kind of overshadowed everybody.
Did you go to Woodstock?
Yeah.
Did, were you really?
Yeah.
You were there?
Yeah.
Was that you?
I was the right age, wasn't it?
Yeah, that's what I'm asking,
yeah.
if you were there. You weren't like naked hitchhiking in the street and shit, were you?
Went there with Richie, the guy with the blonde afro on the back of his motorcycle.
Really? I'm just checking.
Wait, hold on.
I'm not. I'm just trying to figure out what is causing. I'd be very surprised. I'm not going to make a big deal out of this. There's like, I have that.
That same hum, that background thing.
It's the J computer.
J, dude, what?
Now, if what I turn else? The gain down, let me hear Jay. Let me hear you, Jay, if I could.
Hi, Jay.
Hey, Jay. Jay, do me a favor. Turn up your mic a little bit, if you would. I just want to test something. I want
Better?
To see. A little bit more, Jay, if you would.
A little bit more, Jay.
That's fine. See, now what I did was I turned my gain down all the way, and I had Jay turn his microphone
up
all the way.
Well, if you're doing the opposite of gain, wouldn't that be loss?
Who the hell is
Isn't
talking?
Isn't the knob marked gain and
yes.
loss?
Yeah, but you know what? It's like, you know, like, watch what happens if I turn my gain up.
See? It's hot. It's
yeah, see, that's what it is. So, you know, it's all that. You know what it is? In Delaware, the squirrels are moving around the cage so quickly to get the internet to work. You know
oh,
what I'm saying?
Boy. You're just going to piss off the whole state
suck.
Of Delaware. All 13 people.
Good morning, Linda.
Mevo sound.
Yes, I know. Thank you. I got a ding. Hold on. All right. I don't know why I have this mental block. Maybe because everybody messes with me every morning like this. Like, I just forget about the Mevo block.
You know, messing. Young man, if you could get here on time in
got
the morning.
It?
Yeah, you're on the air, by the way. I just wanted to say.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. I have to. People said you sounded like you were in a tin can. I'm like, give them a minute, you know. Can you just put a postie on what you have to change, please?
Nobody. It's like as soon as something goes live, right? It's like as soon as the thing goes on, poof.
Right.
2 seconds later, there's no sound, bad picture. You know, it's like and you. I mean, oh Lord, give me a second, guys. Anyway, so but thank you. I appreciate
it. That took like 2 minutes. You didn't. Why don't you just admit that you don't remember?
She's in a good mood this morning. You know why?
Wow.
We had sex last night.
Because you didn't have
sex. You gave her the pipe last night?
We had sex last night. You know, we did. We did the nasty.
You were by yourself and Linda
went
out.
Linda, were you there?
I'll see you later.
I'm telling you right now, she won't admit it, but I know she had a good time. I know she did.
Again, because you were behind closed doors in the bathroom.
Right. She was like, you know, I came home last night. I walked in. She goes, I miss you. I don't see you that often anymore. I said, some of us have to do things to make, you know, things work. And she said, take me. I said, no. She said, why not? I said, I want cereal.
Do you know who lives in my bathroom?
Who lives in your bathroom?
Stevie Nicks.
Oh, Stevie Nicks?
I go in there, shut the light, close my eyes. Stevie Nicks is in there with me and takes me.
Are you still having that Stevie Nicks dream again?
Never going to leave that one at work.
What do you have? You have the hots with Stevie Nicks?
Always have since we dated. It was a long time.
Oh, you dated with Stevie Nicks?
Oh, yeah, for a long time.
The one I like is Melissa, what's her name? Marissa Tomei from My Cousin Vinny.
Okay.
My biological clock is ticking. You know? Oh, my goodness. You know, so. Yeah, you want.
How do you get mud in the tires?
Yeah. I'm trying to find. I was going to throw on a Stevie Nicks song, but I'm not that quick this morning.
Don't do that.
Why? It bring you back bad memories?
Do you know that whole gypsy thing with the dress swirling around in a circle?
Okay.
She did that on top of me once.
Did she really?
Oh, man.
Really? It's like Jay has the hots for Mama Cass.
Louis, side here. What did you do?
I don't even know who the hell that is.
You're going to have to get up and unplug it and plug your headset back in.
Plug this.
I'm not doing it. You know,
Mama Cass?
Yeah. You just caught that?
Who the hell is that?
You don't know who Mama Cass is?
Yes.
No.
Jay doesn't know who Mama Cass is. Mamas and the Papas, the big fat one, the one that died supposedly choking on a ham sandwich. Oh, that was painful watching Jimmy try to kneel. That was painful, Jimmy.
As bad as Bush. That was almost as bad as Little Bush choking on a pretzel.
Did you turn your volume down on your mic?
No, didn't touch it.
All right, turn it up a little bit. Are you good? Let me hear you.
It's about as high as it's going
to
go.
Okay, that'll work. I think somebody let me know. Now, see, now that I want to know if Jay's volume is okay, nobody's telling me anything.
Oh, somebody ding Eric, please.
All right, I'm telling you.
He thrives
on it. Somebody ding me, all right? So anyway, there's a website out there called Reddit, R-E-D-D-I-T, mm-hmm. All right? And they say, at least you've never been fired for throwing frozen donuts at people, right? Or question, maybe you have. So when one Reddit user asked managers of Reddit, what is the stupidest thing that an employee ever did that forced them to be fired? All right, people, they say, unleash the truth. Mm-hmm. And here's the thing. This is one. They say, every year during the holiday season, one of the managers answered this. Every year during the holiday season, I'd warn the new hires. Listen, no matter how tempting it is, do not steal customers' gift cards. We can track it. I will track it. And if I catch you, you will get fired. Every year people try it. Every year people get fired. Don't do it. They do it anyway. Okay, that's called the gift card thief. Then they have the girls that decide to start stealing. Girls that decide to start stealing some of the products from the warehouse and sell them on eBay.
That's a good one.
All right, as brand new with factory warranty. They say it only took a couple of weeks before they started getting calls for tech support for products with serial numbers we did not have registered as sold in the system. Investigations led us straight to the girl. Okay, she's fired, of course, and legal action pursued. But the sad angle of the story is that her father worked there, too, and we were forced to make him stay at home with no pay until it could be determined beyond any doubt that he was not involved.
That sucks.
New guy around 20 years old or so called in sick saying he thinks he had a stroke. Since he lived across the street from the store where we worked, we all then stood and watched through the store's glass door as he packed up his truck with beach gear and drove off with his girlfriend.
I love it.
Fired the next day. Okay. Forging a tip on a receipt like adding $20 wasn't going to get caught.
That's a good one, though.
All right. They said I had an assistant manager who would short the till every single day, $3.64. It was always the same amount, and we could never prove it was him, even though it was clearly lined up with only his shift, day or night, until one day he came back from lunch at Taco Bell in our parking lot, and my other assistant saw his lunch and thought to herself, that looks good, walked across the street on her break, ordered the same thing, $3.64. She immediately came back and told me. I pulled all the drawers, and sure enough, one was short, that exact amount. The kicker, when he was sat down by our DM to be terminated, all they told him was, we know what you've been stealing, and his response was, oh, you finally figured out I was stealing all those Skechers shape-ups? Those shoes were $130 a pair, they say.
Oh, hello.
Yeah. So you open your mouth, you idiot. Anyway. All right. Assistant manager at a restaurant for a while said that one of the newer bussers had called in three times in his first 2 weeks. He called in on Saturday telling that he was deathly sick and could not even get out of bed. Around 9 p.m. after the dinner rush, one of my servers asked me to go check on table 42. I turn the corner, and there is the sick busser, stoned out of his mind with two buddies eating. I guess if you're going to call in and say you're deadly sick, do not go to the restaurant where you work. Okay? Boss had to fire a lady in her office because she lost her marbles when someone ate her bagel from the fridge.
I would, too.
She literally had a tantrum like a toddler. Also, the girl who ate it by mistake. She thought it was a bagel from the office breakfast that they had had earlier that same morning. It was in the same packaging as the office stuff. They say, now I absolutely hate it when people eat my lunch, but the girl who ate the bagel profusely apologized. She even stated that she would go and buy her a new one right on the spot, but the tantrum lady could not let it go. So that ended up being her last night. I had a server tell a customer he was a pussy for ordering white Zinfandel. Hold on.
That's class.
Oh, let's just see who this is. Good morning.
Good morning.
Hello.
Hey, this is Jim with General Electric Home Security. How are you doing today?
I am doing just wonderful. How are you, sir? I'm doing great. How are you doing?
I'm doing fantastic. Thanks for asking.
No, thank you. Before you start talking, I just want to say that thank you for asking me how my day is going. Oh, I think he hung up on me. See that now?
I don't know.
That is,
that's not right.
All right. Now, see, he was an amazing salesperson, was he not?
I think he did a wonderful job.
He was. He had a customer on the phone that was being nice to him, and he hung up on me.
Blew it. Maybe he should be fired.
You know what I'm saying?
And let's probably the one that ate the bagel.
Let's call him back.
You should call him back.
I'm going to. I'm going to call him back and say, why did you hang up on me? It was Jim from General Electric Home Security. You know why? Let me
English.
Tell you something. And the thing that gets me is that Jim has called me every single day of the week this week. Every single day.
Oh.
And I have asked Jim nicely.
Has he hung up on you before?
No, though? But I said to him once, I said it very nicely. I said, do me a favor, take me off the... I told him we have home security. Yeah. You know, I have Linda. I don't need home security.
This is true.
You know? So.
I have a Linda.
See? It goes to a recording.
Yeah, of course.
So, you know, but it gives you a recording saying, do you want to be put on the do not call list? And you say yes, and then the next thing you know, you're
rather
not.
Rather ineffective.
You know?
Yeah.
So I have to, in a second, I'm going to come up. Let me just fix this without knocking.
Is it the cable again?
Hold on.
Let me.
Because this happens every once in a while. There you go. Jimmy got it. So there you go. But again, for whatever reason.
It's the connection. We know that.
For whatever reason. All right. So they said we were talking about reasons that people had gotten fired. This one manager said that he had to fire someone because he had a server tell a customer he was a pussy for ordering white Zinfandel. You know, my daughter is a waitress up in the Poconos. Mm-hmm. She works in a very, very good seafood restaurant, very busy seafood restaurant, you know, and she's had some winners too, you know. But like I said, Dawn on, I think it was New Year's Eve, had a table. She said, Dad, I had a table of 17 and the guy tipped me $1,000. $1,000 tip.
Oh, that's, yeah, the bars and the clubs, that happens a
lot. Unbelievable.
But people drop ridiculous amounts
of
money.
I wish I had $1,000 to tip somebody. I'm glad he tipped my daughter. Thank you very much. But still, you know. So let's see. The guy says, I used to work at a popular coffee chain, and we had this supervisor who was an actor in all of these local community theater things and wanted to get into stand-up comedy. Well, if somebody was funny, he obviously got ticked off that he wasn't the one in the limelight. A new guy was hired who was really funny, and supervisor was always being a dick to him, giving him the shittiest jobs and picking on him. One night, supervisor, this is the guy that has to be in the limelight, one night supervisor is being a complete asshole, and a bunch of us pipe up to tell him to chill out, and he's being a dick. Something snapped, the supervisor absolutely lost it, went into the back room, grabbed a bunch of frozen donuts, and just came out and was throwing them at the funny guy angrily and just swearing at him and berating him. Then he just walked out the back door and walked off down the street. Well, we all thought he quit on the spot, but he just went to smoke a cigarette and came back minutes later. By that point, someone had called the other manager, and she came in and canned him on the spot. He broke down crying at what had to be the most pathetic, snot-ridden scene that this person has ever witnessed. Awesome, they say.
How about the stupidest reason that you've quit a job?
I don't know. Do you have a list?
I don't have a list of reasons why I've quit a job, but I quit a job in a pretty fashionable manner.
Yeah, which was? How did that happen?
And I tied all the shoelaces together.
What did you do?
I used to work at Journeys.
Yeah.
And I tied all the shoelaces together in nasty knots.
Wow.
So that when they went to go sell it to someone, the shoes were all tied up and stuff.
Jeez, you're hardcore, huh?
I put a lot of effort into that. I felt good about that.
I bet you did.
The only job I really quit anything significant was I was driving a team tractor trailer. And we had it. We took a load of greenhouse. We from Four Seasons Greenhouse over here.
Yeah.
We took a load of glass out to California. When we got out to California, we had to pick up a load of oranges. It was this tiny little shack with about 15 Mexican women and two guys out in the field that would pick the oranges, put them into a box, pick it up with a forklift, come over, dump the forklift box into this funnel thing. It would roll down, and the women would be in there physically filling all these bags. Mm-hmm. I had a 53-foot, which is normally a tractor trailer, is 48 feet. I had a 53-foot reefer, which had to be filled front to back, top to bottom, okay? They had nothing ready when I got there, all right? So, mind you, I went to sleep, all right? Yeah, we were a team. We had two of us. The guy I was working with was this fat slob, right? You know, he was a pig, all right? So I took his shit all the way out there, you know, listened to the bullshit and everything like that. Coming back, right, it was my turn to drive, so I'm driving. And he's sleeping in the back, okay? We get about to Memphis, okay? And he wakes up, and he looks at the clock, and he looks at – and I don't know what set him off, but he made this assumption, okay, that I had not made enough time, that I should have made more time for the amount of hours that we were driving. That wasn't the case. He made a mathematical error, okay, because I was making very good time.
Yeah.
I was actually above the time, so I had just about had it. I couldn't take this I couldn't take it anymore, right? I just couldn't. I mean, I only had to go. We had to get up to the Philly market, and then we were going to the Bronx market. We would have been done. It was the moment. I couldn't take this guy anymore. I was like, I had it. So I said to him, I stopped at a truck stop, okay? Yeah. And I went in the front door of the truck stop, and I walked out the back door of the truck stop, and I got into a taxi cab, and I said, take me to the nearest bus station. And I sat at the bus station. It had to be to wait for a bus, which was my stupidity because I was, you know, I acted in anger, which I probably shouldn't have done. But back then there were no cell phones either. So by the time I got to the bus station, I called my boss on a payphone. He's like, they're looking for you. Where are you? I said, I quit. Mm-hmm. What do you mean you quit? I said, I can't take that guy anymore. And the boss is going, damn it. He goes, you're not the only one that does. Apparently this guy just doesn't know how to get along with people. You know, if you're going to be like that, why are you in a team situation? You know, if you want to drive by yourself, then drive by yourself. Yeah, so I ended up sitting in the Greyhound bus terminal, you know, and I couldn't take it anymore. And the guy, the boss is like, well, what am I going to do now? We got to get this truck to, you know, I got to get to the markets. And I'm like, well, you better tell Chubby Boy, you better, you know, put a move on because he's got a lot of driving to do. You know, so that was Chubby Boy.
Chubby Boy.
They say, I knew someone at Subway who did not get fired for going to the washroom or taking off his pants and underwear. He was making sandwiches wearing only an apron and a shirt.
I would do that.
What do you mean you would do that?
The manager laughed at him. I think the entire store must have been on drugs, they say. Hmm.
This happens. Yeah. Doesn't make you a bad person.
No, it does not. So, good morning, Gina.
Good morning.
How are you?
Hey, Gina.
I'm okay. How are you?
I'm good.
Bring your mom to work day.
What's that?
Yeah. Bring your mom to work day.
That was good, Jay. Yeah. That was cute.
It's a good thing she's not right around the corner. She'd be running over there to bitch slap you.
All right.
No, I don't. He's referring to the fact that Eric says that I look like his mother.
Oh, yeah, he does. She has my mom. If I showed you a picture of my mom, they do. They, you know, the same kind of hair and
like Gina.
My mother does look like Gina.
Yep. She's Scottish.
Gina, have you ever quit a job?
Yes,
in crazy fashion.
What?
Yes, I have actually. I was a waitress at a restaurant in Binghamton, New York. That was a Greek restaurant, and the Greek owner was kind of a schmuck, and he would always feel up all the waitresses. And he went by me. He kept trying to grab at me, and I was getting mad. And see, the problem was his wife was the head of the she was like the hostess or whatever, and so she decided where you would what tables you would have. So if he was flirting with you or grabbing at you, then she would give you a shitty section, so you couldn't make any money. So I always tried to avoid him like the plague. Well, one day we were packed. And he was grabbing at me in by the by where we put the salads together in the back. And I told him nicely, I took the ladle of Thousand Island salad dressing, and I told him, don't touch me again. And he did. And I whacked him. I dropped the plate on the floor, so there's salad everywhere, and whacked him upside the head with a ladle that was filled with Thousand Island salad dressing and told him I quit. And I walked out.
Jimmy, when you were a Chippendale, right?
Yeah.
When you were a Chippendale and you didn't get the tip that time and you walked off the stage.
That was it.
Oh, he got a tip, all right.
You know?
Oh, easy. Jeez.
Yeah. You know, I'm trying to.
I've had kind of a shitty morning, though, to be honest. Jay can attest to this because he was on Skype with me and I spilt a full glass of water all over my table where I had everything set up.
Okay.
And the water went everywhere, and I'm like, oh, shit. I threw my headphones all over the front of me, all down on the floor, all over the equipment, everything, and thank God it didn't hurt anything.
Oh, because I was wondering where you were, but I thought maybe you were, like, mad at me because I didn't bring you into Skype right away, and you were just protesting.
No, and then on top of that, then I have Skype ready. Jay and I are talking in Skype, and then all of a sudden my computer decides, for some reason, to update my Skype to the one that doesn't work. So because they haven't worked the bugs out of it yet. So I had to get in touch with Sam, and he saved my ass once again.
Okay.
And fixed it and downloaded it on my computer, the version that works. And so
now you sent me that. You sent me that email. I still have not switched it over, so I'm going to do that after the show today. Friday is actually I look forward to Fridays because Fridays is a light day, if you want to call it that. Although we will have the politics of love at 9 o'clock tonight, but still, I get a chance to really get things done. And because other days during the week now, we're so busy with the shows that we're doing, it's like crazy.
And I'm sure that extra half hour of sleep helped this morning.
You know what? I tell you, I told Jimmy last night, I was sitting here, right?
Uh-huh.
It was about 10 o'clock at night, and I was fine. All of a sudden, Carlos had called me. He's out with Cash Jackson. He's out in Illinois. Cash Jackson is one of the leaders of the groups out there, and he's going to court today, and chances are they're going to lock him up for child support issues, okay? And
Cash or Dr. Carlos?
No, Cash. And and we had loaned him some equipment to be able to, the cameras and stuff that we just bought and everything. Yeah. So we had loaned him some equipment, and he couldn't get it working. So I was like, listen, I'm in the middle of a show called Linda. And I went to put Linda's phone number into my phone. For as many times as I call my wife's cell phone number, I could not remember my wife's cell phone number. So I'm like, and then all of a sudden I started to get a massive headache, and I'm like, and it was a strange like type feeling headache. It wasn't that normal headache type thing. And it was like, I'm thinking to myself, am I having a stroke? I realized it was like, it was just, I was mentally and physically exhausted.
Yeah.
And that's why last night when I got home, I didn't even set my alarm for this morning. Because I figured normally I'll open my eyes at the same time every morning. This morning that didn't happen.
Yeah.
So it was like, and then I called Jimmy, and the phone rings, and I don't get a hello. I get, I know you're running late, that type of thing.
Hey, Eric, I would like you to tell everybody about the new show that we had the other day on Wednesday. That played. Didn't it play Wednesday? Wasn't it LJ's?
Oh, LJ, yes. LJ, ask L. I didn't know what show you were talking about.
Oh, okay. Well, I didn't realize there was more than one that was a new show on Wednesday.
No, though, but I couldn't remember which one you were talking about. What's today, Friday?
Yeah, it was Wednesday, Friday, yeah. And LJ has a...
LJ, yes. He does a show called... LJ James is a broadcaster. LJ has been broadcasting all the way back to the WRCN days with Tom Mealy, and he loves being on radio,
He's good at it.
And he's good. He's a friend of Paul Cantone's. That tells you what I'm talking about, get it?
That tells a lot.
All right,
it?
So there you go.
Yeah.
I'm not saying that in a bad way. How can I say he's a biker?
Okay. Yeah, well, I was wondering why you were tiptoeing around.
All right, so he's a biker. So anyway, LJ and I together LJ and I had come to and started Biker Radio.
Yeah.
And but he loves being on the air, and he loves being on the radio. And he contacted me a couple of months ago, and he's like, he wanted to do a show, but he didn't have a setup in order to be able to do it because he lives upstate now.
Yeah, he lives in the Catskills.
But he got his act together and what he needed to do, and he got it together. And the other night, he was on, and had a lot of people calling
about his show.
People calling in, and he'll get it where it'll be a good show. You know what I'm saying? I'll be dead by that hour of the night, but besides than that, it'll be a good show.
So. But I will tell you that LJ has really, whether it's good advice or not, he has advice for everyone.
Right. He's
so if you ask LJ anything, you can ask anything, and he'll give his opinion. And his opinions are funny. Some of them are serious. He really is, you know how Paulie has a big heart. Pops has such a big heart. He's a little rough around the edges sometimes, but he has a huge heart. And LJ's the same way, so it should be a really good show.
Absolutely. LJ's a good person too. He's got a good way of looking at life and things like that. So
does he play music on this show?
We probably will. I'm not sure how
he
needs
to hear the music.
He's got to get it together.
He played some music, and the music was pretty kick ass.
Yeah, he asked he wanted Motley Crue or Guns N' Roses.
Mm-hmm.
So I played Welcome to the Jungle and that type of stuff. Choice. So
yeah, so the music was pretty cool.
One more of the stupidest things people do to get fired. The last one, it says, manager said, I went on Facebook and recorded themselves. These are people that got fired, and the manager is saying this. Went on Facebook, recorded themselves live, licking a burger patty and putting it on a bun, then putting it together and sending it down the line. We're friends on Facebook. I watched it live. I went in on my day off to fire them.
Nice. Now that's schmucky.
Can't you get arrested for that type of stuff, too?
Yeah, probably.
Yes, you know, I think so.
You know? Yeah. Jay, when you used to do that, did you ever get arrested for that?
No, because I wasn't stupid enough to record it.
Yeah, he does it at home.
I'm sure everybody has seen the one where the guy from Taco Bell pees all over the nachos.
Oh, God, that's...
I did not see... What
I
was
never
it?
Saw that.
I never saw
see that.
That,
or I wouldn't eat Taco Bell.
Big news
Bell.
In Delaware, though.
Is that what they do in Delaware? Is that why they say in Delaware it tastes different than anywhere else? What?
I think it happened in, like, Nebraska.
Yeah. I was telling Jimmy this morning when Phil and Frank had Antonio on the other night, one of the things I found truly amusing was one of the first conversations was Frank wanted to know if they had McDonald's in China, and Phil wanted to know if they had Taco Bell. And they do have a Taco Bell, you know.
I ain't going.
So
not after that story.
Can you imagine Taco Bell in China? Walk in here.
Meow.
You know, I'm sorry.
Oh, jeez.
So,
I have a question.
Taco Brell.
I have a question. Who I'm actually happy about this. Who put the group picture of us on the Cop and Calamity Facebook page?
Of course it was Jay.
Was it? Congratulations, Jay. Thank
Jay
you.
Does all that stuff
thank you. Thank you, Jay.
Also, I want to say a big thank you to Jay because the other day he made a special happy birthday to Matt the Cat from showmecountry.com.
Yeah, that was nice.
It was his birthday, and it was cool. It was cute.
It was.
And it was awesome that you thought of them, and thank you for doing that.
And let's just keep in mind May 23rd, Jay. That's the big birthday.
What's May 23rd? Oh, your birthday?
My birthday.
My dad was the 21st.
Your birthday.
My dad was
so
the 21st
really
of May.
Matt the Cat for Halloween went as an Irishman.
It's so a Scotland. Scotland.
Whatever.
I want you guys to also...
What do you mean, whatever? Don't say that in front of Gina.
Do me a favor. Also, if you talk... if we from this point forward, guys, because if people have been asking me, if we talk about... You cut Sam's head off on this picture, though. I mean, can the picture be adjusted where it can be brought down a little bit more, Jay? You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
I'm not asking you to change it. I don't know if you can... You know, can you adjust if you can just...
So, sure. Yeah,
if you guys, what I'm asking...
So Matt the Cat went as a Scotsman.
Oh, and, I saw that. You made fun kilt. Of... Yeah, that's cool.
You know what a kilt is?
Do I know what a kilt is?
Yeah.
Yeah, every once in a while, like if you're not feeling well, you kind of kilt to the left or kilt to the right.
No,
yeah. I know what a kilt. Do I know what a? No, I'm a dummy. I'm an asshole. I don't know what a kilt is.
This is New York. I stepped on a cockroach
Compliment?
And killed
a
it.
A kilt is what happened to the last guy that called it a dress.
Oh snap!
Oh,
Scottish humor.
Ooh.
I didn't even know that existed.
Work? Are
yeah,
you?
Yeah, we have
planet?
A lot of it. That we're famous.
I can't
for
even
that.
Do my Sean. What's
how
it?
Are you doing, sweetheart? I'm Why'd dead. You blow me
what
back?
Are you? No, how does Sean? What's his name? Sean. What's the guy?
Bagpipes.
The guy that did John. The guy that did Bond.
Bond. James Bond.
No, but the guy. What's the
know.
Scottish guy with the accent? He was in the Untouchables.
The guy who's the
Sean.
Bond in Skyfall. The Bond in Skyfall.
No, the older guy. What's his name? That talks with the accent. He talks like
they
with
all
a
talk with accents. Anybody?
His name is Sean something. Hey, Sean. What's
Sean Connery.
It? That's the name.
Okay.
The second yeah. one.
What
was
are you intending on? What are you planning to do? You know these.
No, I definitely. I think that the best Bond was. It was a. It's a toss up between me. For me, I believe it was the first Bond. He was. He was great. Sean Connery. I think he was the best. But then I liked Roger Moore, too.
I just think Gina likes to be bonded.
What?
I just think Gina likes to be bonded.
The bonded.
No, that's that bondage. Bondage.
Why
that's
is it?
Different
is, is it just me or is anybody else with their Facebook, right? With their Facebook, is anybody else being bombarded on a daily basis by scantily clad, naked young women who are requesting
First
as
off,
friends.
Why are you even complaining about that?
These are skanks. These are skanks.
And I get
skanks
that.
Have a place in this world.
It all, I don't get it. It's like, and it just gets constantly on a
Jimmy
daily
would love
Somebody
that.
Must on a, have put your name or something on one
yeah,
of those groups.
You know, I don't even look at the. And then I told you the other day. Up. I told you the other day. My wife got all mad at me. Like I'm. I used
I'd
to
be mad too if Sam was getting those.
I used to go to the page and look at it real quick because I got to make sure that
I'm
not.
Why are you getting it?
I don't know.
I actually leave here and I go shopping at the mall at Skanks or Us.
You know what? What it is what I can't. I don't even look. But I go to the page, right? Linda's laying in bed next to me, and yeah. I delete it, right? And yeah. She goes, "Did you just confirm her?" And I'm like, "No, I didn't just confirm her." But like now,
do you know here, which button
here,
to push?
Listen, Rita Hedges, okay, Rita, and you look at this, no mutual friends, and you got a girl standing here with a big ass, big boobies, and it's like, you know, and I am so lonely and feel my kitty just melt.
Whoa.
Would you help me? Would you help me to juice? Then I will help you. I'm waiting here, baby.
Purring.
No, I just felt my kitty just melt.
Wow.
All right. That's Rita, okay? Then who else we got
Rita,
here?
Rita wanna she, eat it.
Frem. Then we got Frem. Her name is Frem. Oh, Jimmy, you gotta check this picture out. Frem's got her legs spread, and she's got hair in places where she should. This girl needs to shave. All right,
oh,
she's the down low looks like I look on a day when I don't shave my beard. She lives in Denver. She lives. And Frem's post right here updated her cover photo.
Yes.
Oh, I got a ding. Hi, Linda. All right. Frem's picture. Frem's picture is I like big dick. All right,
well,
that's Frem. Hold on, it gets better.
Now Linda can't argue with that.
All right,
because she calls you a big dick.
Pamela looks like she look. Pamela, if I saw Pamela, I would think Pamela was a dyke. All right, Pamela lives in San Antonio.
Is there another word that you could use that would be more appropriate?
Pam must know the other girl because Pam's picture is. I am so lonely and feel my kitty just melt. Sad face. All right. Let's see. Let me tell you something. The only reason I would contact this girl, because if you got to see this, I'm the size of this girl's ass. She could have Cop and Calamity, No Holds Barred, Internet Radio Morning Show tattooed across her ass on the same freaking line.
With the pictures.
Holy crap. And you know what gets me? It says photos, nothing to show. All right. But her friend, she's got 53 friends.
Yeah.
Not one of them is a woman. Not one. Not one of them is a woman. Ooh, Donald Trump is a friend? No, I'm just kidding. You know?
Stop.
Yeah, and this one's got...
Say that because somebody will pick that up and run with it.
This girl... Well, oh, Lord. Oh, my goodness.
No, I don't... Somehow I don't get all of those. I get rainy day forecast.
I delete them all the time. Listen... I don't like reporting people to Facebook. I don't think that's my place. I really don't, you know, I don't care. I don't want to do that, you know. Hold on.
I'm at Bart Simpson. Oh.
This is,
what is that?
That's Christy Beck.
That would be awesome, Gary, if they do let us into the courtroom. Hi, Kendra. Hi, Connie. Hi, April.
Hold on.
Hi, Stephanie. Are you going to be here? Are you here yet?
I'll just let her know that she's live on the morning show. Let's see if she notices. It's Christy Beck with.
Do we know where we're walking to?
This is Christy Beck. She's live at the cash shack.
Walking around the building.
Find somebody.
Yep.
Let's see if she sees me. Come on, Christy. Look. Look at your phone.
Chaos. Just let it go. Find it.
Would you like to say anything to our Facebook Live viewers?
Oh, am I? It's
facing you.
Oh, okay.
It's not a selfie.
We really need to stop the extortion by the states that are incentivizing.
Christy is live, so I just jumped on her feed for a second.
Not specifically address the rights violations in family court system and efforts to actually extort as much money as possible from the people's federal.
I want to see if she sees this.
Those Social Security funds are a trust fund. That all belong to all of you, and the state maintains no legal right to actually receive any of those funds. CF Bond versus U.S. establishes that to extort money while receiving wages from the taxpayers would be embezzlement of the wages and extortion. So we really need to do something about the crimes that are being committed by the crime syndicate, state of Illinois, in my case, state of Indiana, and stop it immediately.
Excellent. Thank you for that. And what is your name, sir?
Oh, and I'm Christopher Marks.
Christopher Marks. Nice to see you again.
Nice to see you again.
My DC brother.
All right.
Welcome.
I have a question.
Yes.
I have a question. What exactly do these things...
Guy's carrying a sign says, end debtor's prison. He's showing you hope.
That is just an oxymoron.
Fairness.
In any state in America, I think these things have been misplaced. There's one missing.
End debtor's prison.
Yeah, I think that might
have been justice. Truth and justice
truth.
At the top.
Yeah.
But no, we have the scales of justice right there.
Oh, yeah.
Right?
Well,
yeah. Apparently, but as you can see, the scales of justice, right here. Equality, balance, honesty. Wow.
Yeah.
I think...
I'm sorry, we must be in the wrong place. I thought we were at the courthouse.
And what is your name, sir?
My name is Dave Herbert. I'm from Muncie, Indiana. I have lived in Southern California, Oregon, and then Muncie, having to follow my...
This is going live at the Lake County Courthouse.
Let's keep walking.
We're on
the
same side of the sidewalk.
Yeah?
So no one accuses us of blocking the sidewalk.
Okay, right, good point.
But I've lived in... There we are.
Yep.
I've lived in a few different states, having to relocate in order to be with my son, because the courts saw fit...
Training there.
Parent, all the choice and power, and make the other parent, that would be me in this case, turn me into a visitor where I had no say really or anything in my son's life. So they would move from state to state.
Man.
And I would follow just to be a small part of my son's life. So I've had to do that, and it's been a lot of work. And it was just a lot of unnecessary trauma generated by the court and them incentivizing, imbalanced parenting.
Right.
Incentivizing stealing all one parent's resources. And when child support, actually, let's define child support. Child support is two parents
providing love and a home.
Yeah.
and time.
Cold, and after not sleeping for 24 hours, I'm a little bit of a loss for words, but.
Welcome to that. Yeah. That's why I'm having you talk, man.
Yeah. It's like it's worth it just to keep sharing the message, bring awareness that we are living in a state that created a separate class of people that have to live by a separate group of laws. And that new class of people that's been created by the court system is called the non-custodial parent. They are a new class of people that don't get all the same privileges and all the same rights as another class of people the court created called the custodial parents. So, for example...
This is live from the Lake County Courthouse in Illinois, where Cass Jackson is going to have to make an appearance today and possibly be put in jail. But the amount of people that are here right now in protest is truly amazing from all over the country. So we have a live feed. I'm just going to listen to it for a little while longer.
The resource, of the courts and of the police to have the other parent arrested for, virtually just an accusation. I mean, there's all kinds of different levels of rights
that
are violated. Sorry.
That one parent has and another parent doesn't have. And when the power is imbalanced, it generates more greed. When two people hate each other and you give one all the power, what's that person with the power going to do?
Right.
They're going to try and hurt the other parent.
Right.
It just incentivizes people hurting each other.
It's very adversarial, and that's the way they want it. That's what they want. They want conflict because they're profiting off of our conflict, right. And really ultimately off of our children. And yeah. So
they're creating adversaries.
Uh-huh.
Completely unnecessarily for profit. That's all I got.
That's all you got. Well,
that's all I got right now.
I got something.
Okay, we have more. Chris Marks is gonna. So thank you, David. I just before we go to you for a second, I just want to say, great to meet you in person.
Oh, yes.
I have to say something about this guy. This guy and I, we connected in May of 2013. I was going through my court battle, and it was his video that I saw, and I don't know what was the... Do you still have it up?
I think it's still... It's still up.
Okay.
It's still up, and I looked at it the other day, and I was like, oh...
Christy Beck is the host of Mommy Interrupted on this station.
Like
so we're listening. I'm just seeing what's going on here.
There was no support.
You know, it's like I did have my parents,
right?
And you know, and my sisters, and they were cool. And it's like without them, I mean, I probably would have really lost it. So I mean, they gave me a sense of like, no,
you're not crazy. You're okay. Yeah.
These are bad things that are happening, and they're not happening because you're a bad person. They're happening because we live in a system that has creating this torture of
right.
people and dehumanization of people and the brokenness of families. And
exactly.
they just do so much damage
yeah.
for profit. It's like this, you think, oh, that couldn't possibly be how it is, but it is.
Exactly.
And so,
until you experience it, you can't grasp it. Logical people think, well, that couldn't happen. You go to court and the truth will be heard and justice will be served. I thought that was going to be the case. It shouldn't even be about people pitting each other, you know, parents.
I'm gonna move off the sidewalk.
Why is that?
Just.
Are we walking? Okay.
Well,
oh, there's a Lake County guy right there.
Yeah.
Should we just keep walking around?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean.
Or did they say keep walking around, right? And by the way, hi, Cash. I see that you say you're on your way. So Cash is here watching. Thank you guys for watching. Hi, Shelly. Hi, Paige. April. Thank you guys for your virtual support. So what I wanted
to... I got more. I'm starting to get... I'm waking up.
He's waking up now. Wait, wait.
I'm pissed off. Because, you know, when I first made that video years ago, I didn't know how ripped off I was getting. I just knew I was being ripped off, and I was, like, hurting, and
right.
that's all I knew. And
right.
so I shared that.
Right.
That's all I knew what to do. But now... I realize it is a system that is designed to mine people, just like, you know, you would mine for gold.
We're a commodity, really, and yeah. our children are commodities. That's...
It's like we become commodities, and they look at us and they go, we're going to tear that person open. We're going to dehumanize that person.
Right.
So they become objects that we can steal and take
all their resources.
Yeah.
yeah.
And they almost want us to keep us barely alive so that we can.
Nope.
Whoop. So
I guess we'll
can,
do the whole block, you guys?
Yeah,
keep walking?
Sure.
Okay. We're just
so
walking
that
and
we
talking.
We can continue being a slave to that system. And we're, you know, like an abuser that would come, you know, and hurt a victim.
Excuse me. Sorry.
Abuser would come and hurt their victim. And that abuser hopes that victim
that.
Will... you know, grovel and beg them for mercy and forgiveness and all that kind of thing. You know,
that's
that
right.
happens in abusive relationships. Well, the courts have created that abusive relationship with the citizens.
Right.
That are just trying to maybe, you know, have a family or do, you know, raise a child, do their best in the world, be productive. But the courts just see opportunity to create adversarial relationships. They see their opportunity to exploit. They see... And no, I don't know why. I don't know why.
Well, because actually...
Okay, we lost her.
Why?
So,
I mean,
oh, there she is. Sorry.
It's a whole destruction of families. That's what they want. You know, it's... And to really figure out what that is and why they want that, that's a bigger
yeah.
bigger thing.
Okay, before I go to Chris, because I want you to talk, I just want to finish saying how excited I am to see this guy in person for the first time, because his video was one that I saw when I was going through my court battle, and I reached out to him and we had communication. Like, I still hadn't actually been in contact with my daughter, but and then this guy's also, yeah, and then he also went to Standing Rock. So this guy is like the combination of Cash as well. Like, Cash was at Standing Rock, you were at Standing Rock, yeah. And you may and have it, actually been in a circle with Cash.
Yeah, yeah. It's like, I didn't realize that he was going through the same things I was going through. I just saw this guy, I mean, you couldn't miss him at Standing Rock. He's tall, in full uniform, and he had the energy of, man, of 1,000 people, and dancing his circle dance, and I'm like, okay, just grab my hand. I'm like, whoa, here we go. We're dancing with this big guy pulling me around. And I'm like, this guy's cool. Who is he? And then I never got to connect with him. And then I saw a video.
Right.
And I was like, yeah.
Yeah, and then you and I were like, wait a second.
I relate. I know exactly what you're going through. I've been in your shoes. You know, so Cash, yeah, I've been in your shoes. And we'll probably continue crossing paths, being in each other's shoes.
Right.
So that's why I'm here.
So, yeah, thanks. And where can people go? Do you want people to, you know, your YouTube videos, anything you'd like people to go to? Or
you know, okay, I don't want to get, okay, too long of a story, but okay, I'll try to shorten it. Standing Rock, okay.
Let's keep walking. All right. And Chris, you're next. Okay. Sorry.
Because I've dealt with this stuff for so many years, 18 years.
And how old is your son? Going,
he's almost 18.
Okay.
So I've been dealing this with this stuff since he was before born.
Oh my gosh.
I've been
gosh.
Dealing with this. So he hasn't had his parents together. He's managed to enjoy his life, miraculously. That's another long, long story.
We'll and do you that. See him?
I do see him. Right now, we're in Muncie, and then they moved to Toledo.
Oh gosh.
After another state. And since he's older, I decided not to chase him. Because by the time I get established there, he'll be off and doing his thing, or whatever.
And
so I drive up every week to go visit, and we hang out and go to a movie, go to dinner, and talk and do things. And
so you have.
Okay, that was live. We wanted to follow them a little bit because of what's going on out there. A lot of people, like Dr. Carlos and Christy Beck, and people that are associated with the station, have taken their time and their money and their expense and traveled out to Illinois. So,
I did try to add her to the call and she didn't respond.
So yeah, well, that's because she's on her phone.
Yeah, well, we'll see if we can get her before the end of the show. Yeah.
Now, what's going on out there, Eric?
Cash Jackson, who is retired United States Navy, is involved with a situation in parental alienation and dealing with and what most people are claiming, an unfair family court. And what happens here is, and it's true because I've seen it happen here, what happens is there is no balance with regards to the family court system. One parent, it always seems that one parent is, for instance, with Carlos's situation, or even with Cash Jackson's situation, the parent that is not the custodial parent, or the parent that is not in possession of the children, ends up being financially destroyed, all right, threatened, you know. I mean, here's the thing. With me, when I was paying child support, okay, I was treated, as far as I'm concerned, I was treated fairly. I guess a lot of what, until after the fact, you know, and it wasn't the court was making it unfair. It was my ex-wife, okay? And that's the thing. The court system allows the ex-wives, okay, to make the determination. Like, they'll actually sit there. You'll actually sit there in the courtroom and listen to the, I'll call her the judge, all right? Say to, what is, keeps beeping here?
Because you have the notifications turned on.
No, I don't. I do not. I have Facebook up, and that's why it's doing this on the main computer. So what happens is the court will say to, like, if Gina was my ex-wife, let's say, for instance, and Jimmy was the judge would look at Jim. Jimmy would say to me, "No, Mr. Koppelman."
Sit down, Mr. Koppelman. I will speak.
You're to pay $300 a month, okay? and you're behind on your child support by $2,500. Do you have that $2,500 today, Mr. Koppelman? And I would say, no, Your Honor. And they would say something to the effect of, well, what do you plan? I would like to make a payment arrangement where, let's say, my normal payment would be $130 a week. I'm willing to pay $200 a week, Your Honor, for the past due balance. Now, normally, a judge would hear that and say, okay, he's trying. He's not in contempt of court because he has been paying something, okay? But instead, they look at Mrs. Koppelman, all right, and they say to her, is that acceptable to you?
No, it's not acceptable.
It's not acceptable. What do you want? I want him in jail.
Oh, really?
And that's what happens. So that's why Carlos, you know, Carlos is in a real mess because what Carlos did was when all the shit hit the fan, and he'll be, you know, and there's a big story behind why he is divorced, and there's nothing worse than the scorn of a woman. All right. But he agreed to pay $15,000 a month in child support. He is now $500,000 owed in child support, which he can have. And the thing about it is that this child support doesn't stop. It earns a significant amount of interest, okay, that just keeps – and then plus they put him in jail. So the question is, how do you put somebody – if you're going to put somebody in jail, if you're going to take away somebody's driver's license, if you're going to do all these things to punish this person for not paying their child support, how do you expect them to pay it? Is it not stupid to think that you can take away somebody's ability to be able to make a living and still expect them to pay, and then while they're in jail, be adding up interest and still be, you know, it's not like, okay, I'm going to jail, so it stops because I can't, there's no way I'm going to be able to pay this from jail, so how can you expect me to pay for, no, that's not what happens. It keeps racking up and racking up and racking up.
I want to see and a judge. I also want to say something face. That my daughter shared a post with me the other day, a news story about how in New York they want to make it so that if you're delinquent in child support that you cannot register a vehicle.
Oh, yeah.
So well, now not well, only do you lose your license, you can't go to jail, but now you're going to lose your right to register a vehicle.
My situation, and I'm not going to get into it too deep, all right, with the child support situation was it's not right and you can't and you can't go back and correct it.
How do you come up with a figure? I don't care what your income is.
Right.
How do you come up with a figure of $15,000 a month?
That's what cash is. That's, you know, here's society, here's the thing.
Let me do this. I need to do this and get this one off my chest.
Go ahead, please.
A shout out to my ex-wife. We are not in contact with each other. We have nothing in common except children.
Right.
And a couple of grandchildren. And as in any divorce, there were enough bad feelings to fill a book on both sides.
Right.
I never, ever had this problem. I never, innocent, stupid, ignorant, whatever, I never knew it existed to this degree.
Right.
We shared two children. They came to my house on the weekends. They were with her during the week.
I get it.
If in a pinch, can you go pick up the kids at school? And I'm not saying we were better than anybody else. I never heard of this crap going on.
Well, not only that, but I got to tell you this. For instance, there's a lot of people out there that don't know that this exists. For instance, Christy Beck with her video, live video right now, within seconds of her being on, she had 42 people that were watching her. Mm-hmm. Carlos, some of Carlos's shows have generated thousands of individuals. Actually, believe it or not, in best interest of the children, is as far as ratings go, far as numbers go, is the number one show on this station as far as people watch and listen. It is across the country. While some people might feel that if you're not experiencing this, if you've never known about it, you might find it boring. But to be perfectly,
and this happens to people that actually pay child support too.
Oh, right? Absolutely.
That do what they're supposed to do and bow to these women that make outrageous demands, and they do everything that they can because they want to see their kids, and they put up
and
with
the thing is there's people out, and this is what happens, Jim, is there's people out there that are not being allowed to see their children.
Yeah, they brainwash
understand.
Their
that's
kids.
It. You know, I mean,
that's another
way that you can see their kids is if you go and fight and have to go to court and fight, and yeah,
then still not be able to see
all
them.
The money, and then they tell you, well, maybe you can. Okay, you can see them every other weekend, mm-hmm. and, but yet you can't go with splitting holidays or anything like that. If it doesn't fall on your weekend, then screw you. You don't get to see your kids.
Parents kidnap their kids. I mean, I had a friend of mine who I had to drive with. I drove with him down to Virginia.
Yeah.
Because his ex finally agreed to give him the children. She had kidnapped the kids. They had no idea where they were. All right. We found her. Steven made contact with her. Yeah. And then we drove down to Virginia to meet them to take the kids. Because Steve would have been, at this point, he finally eventually did get the children. But he would have been the better parent as far as stability goes. We drove all the way down to Virginia. She didn't show up.
Oh, shit.
All right, she didn't show up. And then when he went to the property where she was living, she had moved.
Well, Eric, like I said, seriously, Eric,
it's crazy. It really is.
A feather many people in many different forms.
A feather in my what?
A feather in your cap.
Thank you. For what?
Until I came to this station.
All right.
I never, ever would have heard any of this stuff.
Right. That's I. Me too. I didn't realize how rampant this was across
the country. I understood that people...
What about the ones that talk crap about the other parent?
Oh, yeah.
In front of the kids, of course.
That is not good. Oh, your father's this, your father's that, your mother's this, your mother's that. That's not good.
None of it is good.
And when they get to be adults, they then think that they're entitled.
Right.
And then they are treating one parent, if they live with their mother, and the mother talks crap about the father, when they become an adult at 18... then the child has been brainwashed for so many years that the disrespect is rampant to the other parent
right.
when they don't know the full story.
We got a caller. Hold on 1 second. Caller, you're on the air. Who's calling, please?
Hey, this is Sam. I'm calling from Australia.
Sam calling from Australia?
Oh,
all right. You know what? We got to really...
Eric.
I'm sorry. Go ahead. Now, let me hear you now. I might have you better. Let me hear you.
Oh, this is Ben calling from Australia. Actually, I'm in New York at the moment.
Hello, Ben. How are you? Welcome to Cop and Calamity in the Morning. What do you have to say,
Thank
Ben?
You.
What would you like to say? You're on the air, by the way, so what would you like to say?
Oh, I was told to call because I've brought a bunch of celebrities with me who are all excited about the inauguration day.
Absolutely. I'm sorry. You know what? We're going to shift gears here. I have a surprise for you guys.
Oh,
we have. Being inauguration day... Okay, and being the contacts that I have, okay, I was able to make contact, and Ben is with an agency that, Ben, why don't you just introduce the guests that you have with you today, if you would, sir?
Well, I went straight to the top, and I figured why not get the man himself who's being inaugurated today, Donald Trump, he's
surprise,
with me right
guys,
now.
Surprise. So can we talk to Mr. Trump?
Are you really excited? I am very excited today because today is Donald Trump Day, Inauguration Day, and we're going to make America great again. It's fantastic. It's really, really good.
Mr. Trump.
A lot of people have been getting into the spirit of the swearing in because a lot of Democrats, they've been swearing in at me directly. It's fantastic.
Mr. Trump, it's an honor and a pleasure to have you on the show this morning. Good morning,
Thank
sir.
Thank you.
Good morning. So now you guys are going to be moving into the White House today. I saw the moving truck pictures of...
I know. It's a downsize. Melania's got happy. But we're all going to make cutbacks for this country.
Absolutely, absolutely. What do you plan on doing as soon like today? You're going to take the oath of office, and you're going to move into the White House. So, what are some of the first? What are you going to do as President of the United States? What's going to happen?
Well, I think I'm going to just answer a lot of phone calls today because it's my day. We're going to celebrate. We're going to party. And I got a call earlier from Hillary congratulating me, and she said, "Don't hang up on me, Donald." And I said, "I won't because I know you only get one call from prison."
Oh.
I'm joking. I'm joking. I'm kidding. She gets two. I believe.
I'm
joking.
That's
good.
So
we're going to go in. We're going to remodel it. We're going to put a casino in the lobby. And we've already scoped it out. We had a meeting with Barack Obama and Michelle. They were very nice, by the way. Very nice. Michelle Obama said to Melania what a classy lady she was. And what a delight it was to meet her. And Melania said, she said exactly the same thing, word for word. It was uncanny. I can't believe it. Who did that?
So what would you guys like to say to Mr. Trump? Let's start with Jimmy. Jimmy, any I know you're a big Trump fan, Jimmy, so I'll start with you. Actually, Mr. Trump, we do have somebody that wanted to talk to you here. Julio, are you there, sir?
See, Mr. Trump? Excuse me, Senor Trump.
Yeah.
I'm the guy who you contracted with my company to build the wall in the Mexico, the wall. And I'm taking care of my guys over here, a lot of labor. But and the trucks and the fuel, everything, and the bricks. You got any idea how much the bricks so far? I don't see a check so far. I got to talk.
I don't know, but we're getting, I've been talking with the president of Mexico, Enrique Iglesias. And he said, we're negotiating because I don't think we need to build a wall because, let's face it, nobody wants to come to America right now. So I think we could just skip the wall, and I think we could deal more with China because they build a great wall. Let's just leave it at that.
Mr. Trump, I got the wall half built already. What do you want me to do
maybe
now?
Maybe you can be hired.
Okay, maybe we can convert it into a casino. Let's talk about that.
Okay, we're going to redesign. I talk to you later.
Maybe Julio, you could work as a landscaper at the White House. What do you think?
Oh, that's it. Listen,
I think that would be great.
We could make America green again, right?
I like where you're going with that. That's fantastic. That's my green policy. And you know what? I miss Mexico. I not only do I miss Mexico, I miss Venezuela, miss Colombia. It's Thailand. They're all fantastic. Get out of debt. I gotta stay.
And I gotta tell you, we miss Melania.
Melania.
Believe me. But she's getting a little old now. And look, she asked me, she said, would you remarry? And I said, only if the worst possible tragedy ever happened. I would never want to go there. But if it did, and she got really ugly, I would have to. So I didn't want that to happen.
Jay, what would you like to say to Mr. Trump, Jay? What would you like to say?
Actually, I just have a quick question for you. A lot of people are concerned about your hand size. You you want to resolve that?
Your hand size.
My hand size. You know, I got to say, I might have small hands, but my shoes are really big, and I think that's what counts.
There you go. Gina.
My shoe size, yeah. It doesn't really match up to the rest of me, if you know what I'm saying. Size doesn't matter. It's fantastic.
Gina, does size matter, Gina?
Mr. Trump, I have a question for you.
Look at her smiling.
There you go.
Try to make a statement, but I'll take it.
Go ahead.
No, I have a question. Mr. Trump, even though there's supposed to be huge demonstrations against your inauguration today, and some of the people are claiming that you're an illegitimate president, what do you have to say to that?
Listen, I don't know who these people are, but it's all rigged, believe me. I think I have no idea who these people are, but I have got a lot of people that are going to get onto this, and I wanted Sylvester Stallone to be my arts minister. I think I'm going to get someone like him, because he's really good at beating these guys, and I've got Arnold Schwarzenegger who's working for me, because he's working for me, so I've got it covered.
Actually, Mr. Trump, we do have we have another caller here for you, sir. Somebody that would like to congratulate you on winning the election. Mr. Putin, are you there, sir?
I am on the line for Mr. Trump.
Vladimir.
It's great to speak.
Donny boy, how are you? I cannot
believe it. I actually didn't know you spoke English, but that's not really good to speak English.
Not complete fluently, but enough to make conversation with you.
I am
ecstatic for you. I'm walking around so excited. I got the big boner.
With your shirt off, right, Vlad?
You want to look? You want to see chest hairs?
Because I would love to.
I am.
Mr. Putin, is it true that you that the Russians? Oh, he's showing his chest. Mr. Putin, is it true that the Russians had an involvement in rigging the election?
Small influence, just a little bit of influence, and you know what is? We consider this in America. You call this advertising?
Okay.
We had small influence over here. There.
So you are friends with Mr. Trump.
tighter than the head of a drum. We are like, what do you call in America? Asshole buddies.
Asshole buddies. So, Mr. Trump, what would you like to see say to Vladimir Putin?
Yeah, I would love. We're going to do a lot more work together, and I think we could get you in the sequel for Despicable Me because you sound better than Gru.
Perhaps we worked something out. Thank you very much, Donald.
We will work something out. I have a couple other people here that want to say hi.
Oh, please, if you would. Who do we
have? Celebrity.
Please.
Well, he's taken over my position as celebrity host apprentice, and it's just by doing that, he's made America great again. And I have Arnold Schwarzenegger here.
Arnold, we'd love to hear from Arnold.
Yeah, I have questions for Arnold. Yeah.
Hey, Arnold.
Fantastic to speak to you guys. Thank you so much.
Arnold, I love you.
I'll be back.
I love your movies. Gina, what do you have to say to Arnold?
I want to know how his son is doing by the maid.
How my son is doing by the maid.
Yeah.
Listen, it's really hard to keep up with all my children. I'm like, you know, how many children have I got? You know, four or five. Who's your daddy? What does he do? I can't keep up with it. It's like I was the Terminator, but then it became the Impregnator. It's crazy. But he's doing fantastic. He's hoping to get into the movies and the bodybuilding because I'm getting pretty old now. Instead of being the Conan the Barbarian, I'm going to be doing Conan the Librarian.
You have a walker.
Jimmy, it didn't do it. Jimmy, if you could.
I have a walker.
Yeah.
And instead of saying, I'll be back, it's, be back.
I'll be back. Hey, Arnold, you know, I do have a question for Arnold here. Arnold, what's the story with the housemaid that you kind of had a little bit of an affair with there? What happened with, and you know, the child? I mean,
when you were married.
Yeah,
to,
when you were married to Marie, to Miss Shriver.
Yeah, I mean, what can I say? It's all in the news, and but it's all in the past now, and we're doing a movie about it called True Lies 2, so who knows what's going to happen.
True Lies 2. That's funny.
Or maybe the Predator of a different kind. Who knows?
Who knows? I got you, Arnold. I got you.
Yeah, but she's a fantastic woman.
So what is going to be your place in the Trump White House, Arnold? I mean, you're doing the Apprentice. Do you enjoy doing the show?
I love doing the show. It's wonderful because you get to. Donald Trump had the, you know, the catchphrase "You're fired."
Right.
But instead of changing it to say, "You're fired," "You're terminated." Get out of here, hasta la vista, baby.
There you go. Oh, that's great.
We're gonna add a little bit more, and we're getting some well-known big names on it. We've got and you know, interviewing people for season two. I've already got Owen Wilson here. He's here with me right now.
Oh, Owen is there. Really? Can we say hello?
Yeah,
to
Yeah. Wow. We're just having chats about Celebrity Apprentice Part Two. Wow. Great. Yeah. So excited.
He says wow all the time. It's crazy.
He says
yeah.
Wow.
Wow.
Wow. I got to tell you, this crazy. Is fabulous. We
also got Homer Simpson here. I don't know how he did it, but he's here, and I asked him to bring people into the gym. The gym? That is a game. What's a game? No! Somebody give me the number for 911. Get out of here.
Homer, it's I'm a sorry about that. No, it's okay. It's okay. I got it. Why don't you introduce yourself to everybody? Amazing, amazing. You did an amazing job this morning. It was such a pleasure. And you made my morning. You made me smile, and that's a great thing. So why don't you introduce yourself? Tell everybody who you are.
I am all of those people and many more. Yeah, it's Ben Price from Australia, just touring New York at the moment and having a great time.
Absolutely.
What better time to be here at the inauguration?
where you say you're touring? Are you appearing? What's going on? Where are you appearing in New York? Or are you just on vacation?
Yeah, I've had a couple of shows. I'm going to be at Dangerfields on Sunday night.
Oh, really? Cool. I love the Dangerfields on 2nd Avenue in New York City, by the way. Rodney Dangerfield's club.
Yeah,
that's fabulous. Great place. Great place for comedy. So when you do your act, is it a stand-up comedy act, or are you doing your impressions, or are you doing a combination of both? What is it that you do?
Combination of both, yeah.
Good.
It's a bit of me, a bit of Arnold, a bit of Donald Trump, a bit of Homer Simpson, Robert De Niro is a great one, too, and I wanted to punch Trump in the face. It was fantastic. I mean, I'm even doing the face right now.
it's hard to see, but
no, you got
these guys are all going to be there, and and a little bit of Ben Stiller, he's going to make like a little appearance,
Some
of these guys will.
It's amazing.
With me and,
it's amazing how you're able. To, it's amazing how you're able to go from one voice to another, and that's a great thing as an impressionist. That's a fabulous thing to be able to do. And you do the voice. I mean, you really do the voice as well. You really do them well.
Yes, they did very good.
For instance, when I was just listening to you do Schwarzenegger, if I had you on, all right, and I told people that I was interviewing Arnold Schwarzenegger, I would I would say people would believe that that Arnold was actually on the phone with us, and that was a great thing. And even with your Trump impersonation, that's great.
We should do that. Yeah,
we should. So where now? You're from Australia.
From Australia, yeah.
And
from Melbourne.
Melbourne, Australia.
Not, people say Melbourne, but it's we say Melbourne.
Melbourne.
Even though,
Melbourne.
Yeah, even though we wouldn't say the born identity, but we would say Melbourne, Melbourne.
You know what it is?
Whenever I speak a little different in Australia.
Whenever I think of Australia, I picture like Mad Max. when you guys like driving around chasing gasoline trucks, you know, that type of thing. So, but we know
it
that.
Can be a bit, yeah.
Anything?
Oh, I'm glad you picture that rather than the kangaroos and Steve Irwin going, "You little beauty, quacky mate."
and I see the oil tracks that you have down there with the Troy Bayliss classic. So.
Oh, Gina and her racing. There you go.
Oh, that's a big difference.
Oh yeah.
It's really huge there in Australia, actually, too.
Anybody want to say anything to Ben? Anybody?
Yeah, we're pretty sports crazy.
What do you got to say?
What's your last name? I'm joking. Never mind.
I just want to say thank you.
Say, his name is not over. It's not Bend Over.
We weren't going
there.
I think it's great that you called in. I like all your impersonations, and I want to thank you very much for sharing it.
We have to thank Renee for arranging this and making it happen. Making it happen. That was a great thing. So, Ben, how can people check you out? Do you have a website? Do you have a Facebook?
I have a website, benpricecomedy.com, and if you
spell the last
Ben Price Comedy on Facebook as well. I'm on there as well.
Spell the last name if you would.
P-R-I-C-E.
Yeah, no.
That's Price.
Just like the Price is Right. Come on down.
Funny you should say that. You know, we do that all the time. Ben Price.
Eric, you know what? I think we should go on location. We should do a morning show from Australia.
Sure. Yes. Yeah,
we could do that.
I think we need to go to Australia.
Listen, we have
another caller calling in.
Right now, we don't even have enough money in the fund to be able to do a on location from Newark. Okay. All right. So we have another caller calling in, Jay.
Yeah. Give me just a second. I'm trying to connect her now.
On where? Oh, Christy Beck. Ben, I want to say it's been a pleasure to have you on.
Thank you so much.
Me laugh. You made us smile. And everybody out there, check him out. It's BenPriceComedy.com. His name is Ben Price. Look him up on Facebook. Check out his website.
Can we call you again, Ben?
Yeah, Ben, I'm going to check
you out. Yeah, let's do it.
We would love to have you on again. You know, listen, let me tell you something. You are set. All right, at least for the next 4 years, because with the ability to be able to do Trump the way you do it, and that's a fabulous thing. I mean, you are going to be high in demand.
But let's keep it to 4 years.
Thank you.
Don't start, Jimmy. All right,
hey.
Mr. Trump.
Silver lining at the end of the day. It's going to be really, really huge. It's bigly exciting. I can't wait.
Absolutely.
Good luck with your first.
What would you like to say? You know, what would you like to say to Jimmy? He's not necessarily one of your supporters, Mr. Trump. So, what would you say to Jimmy the Voice Jacobs?
I don't know, listen, a lot of people are very, very upset. There's demonstrators, but listen, you got to remember, Hillary, she came second. And second is fantastic, especially for a lady. I think she did such a great job. So I think be excited.
There you go.
Yeah, Mr. Trump, as long as you understand.
That was very wrong to say, but I think be excited. It's going to be great. We're going to make America great again. Get on board the Trump train.
Actually, we do have a supporter. Vinny the Nose from Brooklyn would like to talk to you, Mr. Trump. He's calling in. Vinny,
am I on the phone over here? Hey, Koppelman.
Yeah,
get out of the way.
You on the phone.
Mr. Trump, you're going to do something right, or we're going to come and visit your ass in the White House. Do you understand what the hell I'm saying? All right?
I understand.
Oh, you better understand, because I know you're a New Yorker.
Actually, Vinny aren't you here to collect the rent on the Trump Towers?
Vinny, the thing is that he's worked with you guys so that he's been in New York and built towers here in New York. I'm sure he's dealt with your family many, many times.
Oh, he's dealt with the family. Now, let me tell you, If the bills don't get paid on time this time, you, your friends in the White House, you can all come down to Brooklyn and kiss my ass.
All right. Thank you, Vinny the Nose.
Thank you. That's great. All right. Good catch up again.
Ben Price, everybody. I
thank you, Ben. It was great.
Thank you, guys.
Ben Price, so BenPriceComedy.com. Check him out once again, BenPriceComedy.com. Ben, we are going to be in touch with you again. We want to have you back on the show. I'd love that. I'd love to have you on as a regular.
I'd love to come back.
Absolutely.
Ben, yeah, it sounds awesome.
Absolutely. Thank you so much.
Thanks, right. guys.
Bye-bye.
Take care.
Bye-bye.
Have a great day.
Bye-bye. See you. You too. Bye-bye.
Gina, that was so cool.
Ben actually, looks a little bit like Sam.
Really?
Yeah, check out his website, BenPrice.com.
You're going to have to.
Ben Price Comedy. Absolutely.
Well, for me, there's nobody but Sam.
I know.
Oh, my God.
I love my... Why are you barfing? Just because I'm happy doesn't mean
we're glad you're happy.
I'm just so tired of hearing my soulmate. He's my knight in shining
really
armor.
Happy
he's
is
more
okay,
like a retard
Gina,
in tinfoil, but if he fits the job, he'll do.
Hey. Let me explain something to you. That was just like crossing line. Like I said, you can pick on me all you want, but don't go after Sam or we'll have a problem.
I'm allowed to. I cut you, buddy. I'm allowed to. He hit me with a microphone.
Oh, you get over that. You're such a baby. You've been crying over that for how long now? Over 2 months now. You've been whining about he whacked you in the head with the microphone.
Good morning. Good morning, Renee. Good morning.
This morning, right?
Renee, who?
Renee, are you there? Hello?
Renee, who?
She's just calling my phone. Hold on.
I guess he just made that up.
Renee, are you there? Hold on. Renee? Hold on. Renee, are you there?
And besides, he's my retardant tinfoil, so leave him alone.
All right. Renee just called my phone, but I went to answer, and she's not there. So
this morning, right, I called Gina to let her know that we're running a little late.
Yeah.
And I see Sam. He leaned over. He answered the scarf for her. He leans over to kiss her. And I'm like, that's really sweet. So I pucker up, and he reaches in his pocket and hands me the middle finger. I'm like,
oh, that's
first thing in the morning. That's what I get. All right. It's going to be one of those
things. We've trained him well.
I got the same thing first thing this morning, but it was my wife, not somebody on Skype.
Yeah. So, all right. We're going to take a short break, and we will be right back right after this.
Hey, it's Jace from Cop and Calamity in the Morning, and you're listening to WLINY, America's number one internet radio station.
It's a little bit funny, this feeling inside. I'm not one of those who can easily hide. I don't have much money, but boy, if I did, I'd buy a big house where we both could live. If I was a sculptor, but then again, no, or a man who makes potions in a traveling show. I know it's not much, but it's the best I can do. My gift is my song, and this one's for you. You can tell everybody this is your song. It may be quite simple, but now that it's done, I hope you don't mind. I hope you don't mind that I put down in words how wonderful life is while you're in the world. The moss, well, a few of the verses, well, they've got me quite cross. But the sun's been quite kind while I wrote this song. It's for people like you that keep it turned on. so excuse me for getting, but these things I do, you see I've forgotten if they're green or they're blue. Anyway, the thing is, what I really mean, yours are the sweetest eyes I've ever seen. And you can tell everybody this is the song. It may be quite simple, but now that it's done, I hope you don't mind, I hope you don't mind that I put down in the words how wonderful life is while you're in the world. I hope you don't mind, I hope you don't mind that I put down in the words how wonderful life is while you're in the world.
We've been waiting for a long time. Yes, we've been waiting for a long, long time. We've been waiting for a long time. But we ain't gonna wait no more. We're getting ready to rock and roll. We're going to 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. Well, there's a reason everybody should be shaking in the house tonight. And you should grab your favorite lady and promise her you'll do it right. Tell Fat Cat to jump back and give you a shot of some booze, so you can party to some stomp down, but thump and rock and roll.
Good morning, this is the old man, and just in case you don't know, you're listening to to Cop and Calamity, no holds barred internet radio, right here on WLINY in New York, all over the world. God bless.
Thank you, old man. Thank you. Thank you so much. That's great. That's great.
Was my pleasure.
That was great. Now we have a caller. Actually, we have a caller here. Caller, you are live on the air. Who's calling?
Oh, good morning. Good morning.
Good morning, Miss Beck.
How are you? Christy Beck.
We actually had you.
I'm good. How are you?
Good. We had you on a live feed when you were walking around the sidewalk in the rain.
Oh, did you really?
Yeah.
Awesome.
So how you doing?
And Eric introduced you as Christy Beck, the streetwalker.
That's not nice. She's mad at me because I got her nervous. She got on the plane yesterday, and I was like, "What's the movie? Airplane?" So anyway, Christy, how you doing?
You guys are bad.
How you doing out there?
Doing well. Tension, you know. There's a little anxiety going on, but good group of people here supporting Cash Jackson with his court date today, where he's facing incarceration if he doesn't pay the $3,700 purge amount, which for those listeners of the morning show may not know, but Cash Jackson is the founder of Restoring Freedom and is a parental equality advocate. He is the founder also of Illinois for Parental Equality, and he's a 20-year Navy veteran who has, you know, just look his name up and you'll see a bunch of stuff.
Absolutely. What are the chances that he's going? Is it that if he doesn't pay this morning, he's going to jail? Is that what the story is? Or is that what's going to happen? Or we don't know?
Really? That's what I believe, and he's here in his Navy blues, and I've got photos. I just changed my profile photo to me, Carlos, and him, but I know he was asked to not wear that, and he's wearing it, so we'll just see how it all goes. I don't know what his plan is, actually.
Why was he asked to not wear it?
Yeah, why?
Why do they ask?
Come on, would you like to be on WLIMY this morning?
Christy, why did
they? I've got Cash right here. Hold on.
Oh, good.
Hold on, here's Cash.
Cash?
Hello?
Hey, Cash. Morning. Cash Jackson. Cash, how are you this
morning?
How's everything going, Cash?
I'm doing well.
Cash,
I'm doing well. How are you guys doing?
We're doing well. Cash, of course, a 20-year Navy veteran out in family court today out there in Illinois, facing incarceration, actually debtor's prison at this point with regards to a child support issue. Cash, let me ask you a question, all right? I'm going to ask you this. Why not pay the why not pay the child support?
You know what? That's a fantastic question. And it's not that I don't pay child support. So let me be clear on that. Number one, I do. I pay an average of $1,000 a month, every single month. Mm-hmm. What I have not been able to pay is for child care expenses and extracurricular activities, and that's what I was held in contempt for. That's why they set my purge at $3,700. But it's a matter of principle. You know what I mean? It's no different than what Martin Luther King Jr. did, what Rosa Parks did, is that even though something is legal, doesn't mean that it's moral. And we live in an immoral judicial system, one in which it persecutes parents for just wanting to love and to raise their children. And that's one.
When you were here, when you were on the air with me a few months ago, you had told me or you had said that you were dealing with the parental alienation situation where you were not able to see your children. Has that since changed? Has that since changed, or are you still in a position where you're not able to see your kids?
No, I do see them. I pick them up for a few hours throughout the week. So on Mondays, Thursdays, and Fridays, I pick them up for about 3 hours after school, and I have two overnights a month. And essentially, they're using my activism, continuing to use my activism against me. The guardian ad litem in this case has stated that she will not recommend consecutive overnights with my children unless I exercise 100% of my parenting time for an undisclosed duration. Mm. So she said, as long as I have an ongoing court case, then I stated, well, this court case should be ongoing for the next 10 years, and you cannot restrict my liberties and use my children as a weapon to do that, and that's what they're attempting to do to me.
Are they gonna put you in jail today, Cash?
That I do not know, my friend.
Okay.
Now, Cash, I have a question for you.
Hold on 1 second, Jay. Do we get to you 1 second, Jay? Go. Are we going to say cash? You don't know.
I was verbally ordered by this judge to not wear my uniform into his courtroom because I'm retired from the Navy.
Okay.
And he informed me that he would call the Department of Justice, which is the inappropriate agency, but that he would call the Department of Justice if I wore my uniform into his courtroom again. And I have that uniform on right now.
Okay.
So,
gotcha. Why is there a regulation where you're not allowed to wear it after you're retired?
There are regulations that dictate the manner of wear and when it's appropriate. And some of that is subjective. But for me, it's an exercise of free speech. I served in the United States Navy for 20 years honorably, was discharged honorably. And so I will wear this uniform anytime that I feel that it warrants it. And in this case, it warrants it.
Absolutely.
Now, are you expected to have any blowback from the military for doing this?
Well, that's what...
That's always a possibility.
Yeah, I mean, the Department of Justice, that's not the agency that... The bottom line...
He's asking if he's going to get in trouble.
You know what it is? It's a fine line, because the bottom line, he's not wearing... It's not like there's a lot of guys out there that wear uniforms that are never been that have never served. You know, you see the videos out there all the time of the people that claim to be airborne rangers, and they're not. You know, Cash is a 20... He was a company commander, boot camp company commander in the Navy. He was a senior... You know, petty officer. He's not a joke. You know what I'm saying? And I mean, the bottom line is he's not a bum. He's paying his child support. So how are you in contempt of court if you're paying your child support, but you can't afford to pay an additional amount that the court is demanding you to pay, which is what a lot of these courts are doing. They're saying, you have to pay this, and the people are turning around and saying, okay, that's great, but where would you like me to get it from? You're doing everything in your power to stop me from being able to earn a living, and then you expect me to be able to pay an excessive amount that I can't afford. Where is the fairness? Where is the balance? I think that's what these people, you know, that's what Cash and his group are trying to say. They're not saying we don't want to support our children. They're not saying we don't want to be fathers. They're saying a court, a judge, do me a favor, balance this out, make it fair. You know what I'm saying? Make it fair. You know what? And I'm sorry to say it like this, but even the father that doesn't have custody of his children needs to be able to live. And when that father can't, and when you can't afford to feed yourself, to put gasoline in your car, you know, something's wrong with the system. You know, women do not need, I'm sorry, mothers do not need $15,000 a month to support children. They don't need it. Jay, what were you going to say? Jay, you had a question?
He actually, you already addressed my question regarding the uniform.
The uniform, all right.
So, hey, man, I got to run.
I understand. Well, listen, Cash, we wish you the best. We're praying to be able to talk to you after you walk out of court today. So, all right.
I appreciate it, fellas.
All right, no problem. I stand behind you. Christy, are you there?
Hang on. They have to hand the phone back over.
All right.
Jay, did you want to give him any advice on showering or anything?
Hello. So I'm back on.
Hey,
I'm
Christy,
on
yes, you are.
I'm about to walk in as well.
All right, Christy, we love you. Stay calm. And just remember that there's a lot of people out there that are supporting Cash, that support you, that realize and are starting to see. Like Jimmy was saying this morning, he never knew. He never realized stuff like this was going on. And
I never knew that it happened to so many people.
Oh, absolutely.
I thought it was just a small field.
No, it's all across the country. So,
God bless you for getting the news out.
So, like I said,
thank you very much.
We love you,
Miss. Peace out, you guys.
All right, peace.
Take care.
Be safe. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Okay, so we're letting Christy go. All right.
Yeah, I feel bad about this. I think it's a bigger problem than...
Gina, I can almost understand the rationale of the court in that if either party did anything wrong, there is a little bit of, well, you married the moron kind of a thing, that attitude. But we keep saying the same thing. But the kids are the ones that are getting screwed.
Right, yeah.
But then there's people out there. See, this is the thing that I don't understand, okay? There, if you have a decent job, okay,
yes.
They're screwing you. Like he had said, he pays $1,000 a month, okay?
Yeah.
And I know people that are raising kids by themselves by a deadbeat father who has a hard time paying $25 a month.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Because he won't work. And if he does work, he works off the table. Yeah. And they allowed him to get a $25 a month for three kids. And right. now she's working two or three jobs trying to keep the kids, to, you know, take care of them. Mm-hmm. And they don't do anything about that. So how is that right when if you're poor and sit on your ass and don't work and don't do anything, you only got to pay $25 a month. But if you're working in the military and only have a certain amount of money, you have to pay $3,500 a month for extracurricular activities. I mean, come on. That's a little bit
much. But you know the
much.
Truth. In almost every marriage, I'm sorry, in almost every divorce, at the end of a marriage, in almost every case, two parties were at fault. And in 100% every single case, the kids were not at fault.
Right.
And they're the ones getting the serious shift. Husbands and wives, again, you know, I would say to a friend, I would say, you did have something to do with this. You married the bitch. So even if you've done everything right and she did everything wrong, you walked into it with eyes open. Your kids did not. You both brought them into this world innocent and defenseless.
But absolutely. What about the ones that aren't married? You know, this happens to non-married people, too, that have children that aren't married for some reason or another. And then there's this huge thing about taking them to court, getting child support, doing all that. And and I think that, it, you know, if you have a child, I think you should take care of that child. But I don't know if they should, the courts should be as harsh on certain things. Like, I think it's unreasonable, the $15,000 a month for Carlos.
That's a ridiculous number. It's an insane number.
Freaking ridiculous.
It's supposed to be based on what the other spouse has for living expenses.
Linda's just saying that in New York, they only take $25 a year to process the payments. So it's not like that the court gets a lot of money for processing the payments. But I'd like to know, you know, what do you do for that? Because this is a very deep problem that we're having here in America. And I'm glad that Christy and Dr. Carlos are talking about it, because $15,000 or $3,500 a month is ridiculous. How is the father or the other spouse, the mother or the father that are alienated, supposed to live? What, are you going to be homeless on the street and then have to pay $3,500 for your child support so your ex can have a pool?
If you happen to have a boatload of money, maybe it is understandable. And so, you know, if Donald Trump got divorced tomorrow, yeah, I could see that his payments would be insanely
high. He's a billionaire, exactly. Of course.
But for most people, even $1,000 a month, that's a big chunk of money for a lot of people.
And even, okay, like Donald had with Marla Maples, he had that one daughter. And he really paid for everything. They never were in the news. They were never in court. He, after the divorce or they actually initiated the payments, he did what he needed to do to take care of his child.
Yeah.
I agree.
That's what I'm saying. I think that we should be more concerned about the kids having good relationships with their parents and less about the retaliation from the scorned spouse.
I agree. We are going to be on WLNY. We're going to actually broadcast the inauguration live, all right? Oh, cool. Video, with live video as well as audio. So we're going to be doing that this morning to cover this. I have a live feed right now, which is, you know what I find amazing is that the live feed that they're using is live stream, which we are now using. We are now using live stream again. And now, what we've done is we brought back to WLINY TV. All right, which Linda and I had started that back when we started this whole thing. We were actually very much that. And now, in addition to the radio portion of things, if you go to WLNY and we're slowly making the transition to all of our pages, you'll see the TV screen that's on there. And we're going to be more in control of our TV programming as well as our radio programming as well. So thank you for that.
Can I say something about this inauguration, a story that I found today that I really...
Sure, if you would, please. You guys. Go ahead.
North Korea, we all know Kim Jong-un, the little round guy.
Little round guy. That's what his name is. It's not King. We just call him the little round guy. We know who he is.
The little round guy in North Korea. Right. He's been reported that he is readying two intercontinental ballistic missiles to nuke Donald Trump's inauguration. Military officials say the rogue state wants to send a strategic message to the incoming president by timing launches to ruin his big day on Friday. In a statement, South Korea's Joint Chiefs of Staff said that the reports could not be confirmed, but that the military was monitoring the situation closely. Now, the devices are estimated not to exceed 49 feet in length. Now, do you think that they will be able to do this? Do you think it's all saber rattling? Or do you think that this is something that we need to worry about?
I think we're watching it, and I honestly don't think the missiles will get off the ground. Or if they do, you know, North Korea is making a big mistake if they do anything to that effect.
Well, they're also in league with Iran,
yeah,
and some of our other enemies, and they are exchanging information and such. So I'm just wondering if this is at all possible.
Is it possible? Yes. Will it happen? I doubt it. So. Mm.
We'll see.
Don't know.
Was 9/11 possible? No, not a chance in hell.
Yeah, that's true.
Was a president ever going to get shot and killed in a parade in the United States? Never.
Anything could happen.
Anything is possible.
Anything exactly. could happen.
Well, that's true. Kennedy was, and Reagan was shot coming out of a building, and he wasn't even really doing anything that day, and Brady was in a wheelchair the rest of his life.
Right. Yeah, and look what they did, you know.
And it was another. That could never happen. There's too many people around them watching and with guns and what it could never happen, but it did.
Yep. I agree. So,
yeah, anyway. I wanted to let you guys know that. And I have a quotes for today that I think are appropriate.
Sure.
Okay.
Mind. One that says, I cannot even imagine where I would be today if it were not for a handful of friends who have given me a heart of full of joy. Let's face it. More fun. Mm. And it's by Charles Swindoll. And I think that that's really appropriate for the morning show. And I have one from Jimmy Morrison. And it says, a friend is someone who gives you total freedom to be yourself. And I think that that one is a good quote for the morning show, because we all allow each other to be, no matter how crazy, to be ourselves.
Absolutely. I agree. I'm trying to get
nicely
this.
Spoken.
Very good. I'm trying to get the.
All right, go ahead while Eric stumbles.
No, it's time to say goodbye. It really is. It's time to say goodbye. I'm just trying to get this working here, and it's not. So I'm going to go back to the hold on just one
Whatever,
second.
Whatever, dude. Final thoughts?
I was trying to work on something. Yes, absolutely. Final thoughts.
The dumb person who advertised heroin for sale on Facebook and was convicted of conspiracy.
Was it an old person, Gina?
No, this guy, they received a tip that Bernard Big Pat Stokely was advertising heroin on social media site offering specials of the day.
Really? It's inauguration
special. He accepted orders through Facebook and Snapchat and then arranged delivery of the drug in a neighborhood where police have made many drug busts in recent years.
For all elderly liberals who can't face today's inauguration straight.
They said, we had a guy on last night that was saying that when you went into D.C., the smell of pot was in the air. people were drinking all over. It was like one giant, you know, Mardi Gras party.
You know? There's somebody out there right now handing out joints at the inauguration.
Is it really? Oh, yeah, I remember they were saying they were going to do that.
They were rolling 4,200 joints in the name of 420.
See, Jimmy, just for that, we should have gone to the inauguration.
I'm going. Are you kidding me? The car is packed up.
He's ready to go. He's got the Volkswagen bus ready to go.
Dude.
He's out there going, anybody want to go to San Francisco? You know? Anyway. All right. So, Jimmy, parting thoughts if you would, sir.
Yeah. I'm in light of what Gina just said, I am damn grateful for this family that took me off the streets, welcomed me with open arms, and I feel very close to you people. And I feel very close to all the other people that are listening to us and watching us on stream and throwing their ridiculous comments at us. But we're having a good time, and we hope you're having a great time, too.
We are. And we love you, Jimmy. We do. You are now, Jimmy, officially. I named you.
Yes.
I did. Named you. You are Jimmy. And as a matter of fact, I can do things like.
I can't shake that.
I can do things like. Here, we can do things like.
I get teenage girls come up to me in the street and go, oh, it's the boys. Talk to me. Touch me.
I wanted to play you something here. I just got to shut this volume off here for a second. And then I could do things like this. Hold on.
Wait a minute. Hold on.
I'm not playing.
Good morning. This is the old man. And just in case you don't know, you're listening to to Cop and Calamity, no holds barred internet radio, right here on WLINY in New York, all over the world. God bless.
There you go. See that?
That's great, Jimmy. Congratulations. That was good.
Thank you.
So there you go. All right, Jay, if you would, parting thoughts, Jay, please.
Parting thoughts. If you can be anything today, be grateful.
That's it?
I like that.
That's it. You know, be grateful for the air that you're breathing, the fact that you have limbs that work, even if they don't work. Be grateful for the fact that you're not underground. Be grateful for the fact that you have friends that irritate you. And be grateful for the fact that you have dirty dishes because you had food on them before.
I'll address that in 1 second. But Gina, parting thoughts. Are you still there with me, Gina? Because I don't see you.
I'm
okay,
here.
Good. I don't see your camera. But anyway, go ahead.
Yeah, I'm here. I just want to say that... you guys are great. I had a good morning. Everything went wrong that could go wrong for me here, and you still managed to make me laugh and have a good time. I want to thank everybody that's listening on stream, and if any of our social media or any of the apps that we use, we appreciate you, and we'll be back on Monday. Remember, everyone is going through something, so be kind. It doesn't cost you anything, and the rewards can be tremendous.
Absolutely.
Have a great day, everybody.
Absolutely. I am grateful, Jay, and I agree with what all of you said. I am truly grateful for all of you. I know that at times, I know you're going to find this hard to believe, but I know I can be a pain in the ass. I know that.
No.
It's hard to believe. I know. I get it. But you know what? Still, you know, the beautiful thing about a family is we can still hate each other and still get up every morning and act like we don't.
Hate each other. That's not fair. That's not nice to say.
Well, not the rest.
Jay
of us,
told me.
Come on,
Jay,
Eric.
Jay called me yesterday and told me that Gina hates me.
I never said that. I said she wants to kick your ass. There's a difference.
No, oh, that's true. You did say that. No, I'm kidding. I
haven't wanted to kick his ass for a while now.
You two behave.
We have to. Listen, we love you guys. You know, you listeners, it's because of you. You know, I had a doctor tell me once, right? I wouldn't take my blood pressure medication.
Is this a long story?
And she says to me, she comes in. I never used to like to take pills or anything like that, right? So, and my blood pressure was like 190 over or whatever it was. Yeah, it was really extreme.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, so, and I did that. I dealt with that for like years.
Yeah.
Okay? I mean, it was causing me panic attacks and anxiety and erectile dysfunction. Function,
I knew that was coming.
And so anyway, the bottom line.
So did he.
Yes.
So this
doctor comes in. This doctor comes in, and she comes over to me, and she puts her hands on my hands, and she looks me in the eyes, and she says, "We can do this without me, but we can't do this without you." So I kind of went, I like nodded. As she's saying this, I'm nodding my head up and down, yes and no, and I look at her, and I go, "What does that mean?" Right? She never answered the question, "What does it mean?" She let go of my hands, turned around, grabbed her paperwork, and left the room.
She was probably thinking, "Dumbass."
It's one of those that's so deep, I don't understand.
What the hell do you mean by that? You know, am I going to die? Do I have, you know? So let me just say this, all right? Let me just say this. I can do this, you can do this without me, but I can't do this without you. And you guys respond,
"What?
That's so nice.
What does that mean?"
Oh, what does that mean?
Let's try this again.
Okay.
"You can do this without me, but I can't do this without you."
What does that mean?
What does that mean?
All right, somebody write this down.
Come on, can we get it?
Will somebody text Jay the script, please?
Because this Yutz will do this for a half hour.
"I can do this without me, but I can't do this without you."
What does that mean? What the freak does that mean?
Gina, give me a little Show Me Country. We'll end with that today, please, since we were occupied today and didn't get to that. But I don't want to forget them because I love Matt the Cat and his kilt and all that other crap. And
oh, my God. It's a skirt. Come on. It's a skirt.
They're great,
Matt.
People. Okay, showmecountry.com. It's more than a brand. It's a lifestyle. So wear your lifestyle with showmecountry.com today. They have hats. They have T-shirts. They have belts. They have purses. They have all kinds of stuff. So please go check it out and wear your lifestyle with showmecountry.com.
Absolutely. Showmecountry.com. We love you guys. We love everybody out there. Remember, life is what happens. And I'm Jay. I'm going to end this today with a country song of the day. I get it. And usually we'll do with the Madison Rising thing, but we're running over today and I want to make sure we get to the country song
of
the day.
You're the boss. We can't do this.
No, listen, I'm not the boss.
What does that mean?
Let's clarify that.
So you are the boss.
Linda's
tell us all. I'm the boss. boss. You do what I say.
No, Linda's the boss. All right. So
But Linda is definitely.
Wait, it's after 10. Abigail's the boss.
That's
now.
True. Yeah. Everybody have a great day. Remember, life is what happens when you're busy making other plans. Say goodbye, everybody.
So
bye,
long.
Bye, everybody.
It would help if I
love you, Sam.
Do that shit up, man.
Hold on. Let me. You
we
know
all
what?
Love you,
wow.
Sam.
Wow, did I screw up here? Hold on. Why isn't this not? Hold on. Where the
hell?
Hold
on. Wait a minute. Hold on.
Wait. I got it. I got this.
Your balls hang low.
Hold on.
Do they wobble to and fro?
Now. All right. Let's try
it. Can you tie them in a bow?
Can you throw them over your shoulder?
Like a continental soldier, do your balls hang low?
With the windows down, I used to love it. Oh, but I'm over it, man, I'm over it now. I used to leave it playing on repeat. I spun that record till it turned on me. The DJ knows exactly what I need. I need an oddity walking with a new beat. You were the rooftop at the top of my lungs, blowing the speed back of my trunk, and you had your chest then, yeah, but I moved down, and now you're just yesterday's song, yeah, yesterday's song, the soundtrack every night in my bed, you were the boo-boo getting stuck in my head, now you're just an echo when the feeling is gone, baby, now you're just yesterday's song, yeah, yesterday's song. We had a moment. It's lost and you know it. It's just the sound of what we used to be. Yeah, I used to leave it playing on repeat. I spun that record till it turned on me. The DJ knows exactly what I need. A little dancing could be good for me. You were the rooftop at the top of my. Too bright, those blinds, yeah, let's just keep moving.